If you sick of these stations only playing the mainstream, hold up, I got some top shelf radio you can stream. I need that top shelf, it's gotta be top shelf, nothing less than top shelf. I'm fucking with top shelf, only that top shelf. It's gotta be top shelf, nothing less than top shelf. I'm fucking with top shelf, only top shelf. It's gotta be top shelf, nothing less than top shelf. I'm fucking with top shelf, only that top shelf. It's gotta be top shelf, nothing less than top shelf. I'm fucking with top shelf only.
Good evening. Welcome to another episode of Top Shelf Radio. I'm your host, Henny Holyfield. Got my co-host with me, too, man.
You know what I'm talking about.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Simo,
he put the load.
Yeah.
Dodie Unknown.
What's happening? You know what's good with y'all tonight,
Top Shelf
man?
Family. Yo, yo. You know what I mean? Appreciate each and every one of y'all tuning
in. What's up
in,
with Eddie,
man?
Too, man? What's up with you, man?
Eddie Z.
In the tuck.
Oh, he just hit the, oh yeah!
Shout out to that man that hold us down, make us sound good, look good, upgrading every time we step up in here, man. Also, Justin Z, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to him, and then shout out to a incredible 916 back there, you know,
doing it
down too, you know what I'm saying? Make sure shit sound good on the live. Whole 360 Radio family, man. If you're not following us, you need to be. You need to be subscribed and following and commenting on everything that we do. You know what I'm saying? Just to stay tuned with what we got going on. Dope show put together for y'all tonight, man. To my right, we got a LV the Great in the building.
Yeah.
All that.
Got his people that he brought with him too, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna get to know everybody and talk about everything that y'all got going on and you know, after we get into this music, you know what I'm saying? But it's been a dope week, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna talk about the week a little bit. First of all, gotta give a birthday shout out to Jackie Yo.
Yo, happy birthday.
Shout out my whole Skylit team, you know what I'm saying? And unfortunately, you know, I hate having to start the shows with passings, but it seemed like, you know, every 2-3 weeks, every month somebody passed, you know what I'm saying? So we just lost another member of the hip hop community, Slim 400 passed
this week,
you know what I'm saying? And he was in SAC a lot too, you know what I mean?
For sure.
I believe I opened up for him once. So. Definitely sending prayers to his family, man. You know what I'm saying? Always sucks when we losing somebody. But again, that is should encourage you to go and hold your loved ones a little bit closer. You know what I'm saying? Because we don't know when we gonna go. So make sure you tell the people that you love that you feel that way, so they know. You know what I'm saying? What else we got going on, man? We had a live performance in Davis. Me and
How'd that go?
It was lit. You know what I'm saying? It was down in the basement. I don't know if you see my live. Or
I saw, yeah. Like, I checked
records
out.
And shit.
I always get to see everybody else's performance but yours, because I don't see everybody else's feeds but yours. You know what I mean?
Oh, okay.
Like you always filming for everybody. Yeah. It looked tight.
That's tight. Yeah.
Nah, Big Sammy invited us down there. You know what I'm saying? But it was me, Scourge, Jules Verne, and KO.
Yeah.
Hey, the Big Sammy, like, performer, like, rapped at Uptown, huh?
Yeah.
He be spitting, bro. Sorry,
he held it tight.
Hey, he goes hard.
We got a Big Sammy song on the playlist.
Okay, yeah.
We're going to play that.
Shout out to Big Sammy.
Big Sammy. Shout out
the opportunity.
And KDBS, man.
Yeah. And it was the first time they've had some hip-hop in there for a long time. So hopefully it ain't going to be the last time. Hopefully we kick that door open and we can start getting other people to get in there and hop on their radio.
Make a good impression.
Right. That's FM right there, though. You know what I'm saying? 90.5.
Do they still censor shit?
We didn't censor shit.
No, I
think it's certain times of the day, like if you play early in the day, like you got a show,
they'd be like,
earlier. Yeah. We said, can we cuss?
You can cuss on the radio, but you cannot smoke in the city premises whatsoever.
In the city premises?
Isn't that Davis? Davis, you can't smoke in Davis?
You can't smoke
like
on
a street?
No, like the city, right? It's the city, bro.
Like you can't walk around just
like. No. No.
Since when?
Like, no, since forever.
Okay.
Nah.
Okay, nah, since back when we did them shows back in the day.
But
yeah,
you
bro.
Said walking though. Like
on the street smoking a cigarette? No.
Shit, I didn't smoke plenty of cigarettes on the street, so maybe I was doing some illegal shit.
You're a criminal.
But I ain't never
heard that. You're a fucking hood.
But I work on campus, though, and I know that you can't smoke on campus.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, man. From what I recall,
Santa Cruz.
From what I recall, was the
if y'all
whole
know,
city.
He
bro.
Be cooking up. He be cooking up. Be a real chef.
Hey, you got a new dish? You got a new dish too? What was the new dish?
Oh, the screaming shrimp
scampi. Uh-huh, screaming shrimp
scampi. Is that the shit that you brought the pasta?
Nah, that's the pesto. That's the bussin' pesto.
I cook that dish. Cook that dish, huh?
Get it in, uh-huh. Man. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Young boy Somali and Henny on that video and shit.
that pesto pasta was.
Yeah. Bussin'? Was it bussin'?
You had to be there.
I'm gonna bring some more. Don't need a trip, man. I'm gonna bring some more so you can get something, though.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's on the menu. You know what I'm saying? And then they're gonna throw my gumbo on the menu.
Okay.
Sometime in the winter time.
Hey, I'll be whipping up too.
Okay.
We might have to have a cook off.
Come on, stop playing with me.
Okay. Yeah. Hey, Henny need to prove. You know,
give me a recipe. What you want to do?
Give you a recipe.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah. What are you talking about?
Here, give me a recipe. It's a chef up in here.
You can't go no chef competition when you ask for a recipe.
That's not how it works. No, nigga, you want to make, you pick the item, and I'm not, you can make them how you want to make them.
Can I bring up something to talk about real quick? I'm not to change the subject, bro.
Yeah.
Remember when we had this little text thing going on, we thought we was texting Simo? So you gave me your number, but you was one number off on your own number, right? So we texting, and me and Hattie's talking, we just figured you ain't responding. Then you respond. And it's just some thirsty ass chick trying to get us to come hang out. Where y'all at 6:00?
She was like, this ain't Simo. This is
Ray. So-and-so. But short for Rachel. Doing? But what are y'all doing? Yeah.
Yeah. Like, hold on. Calm down.
Like, bruh.
She was trying to tap in.
She was trying to come to Lord
University.
Trying to get me in trouble twice this week. Then I get late night text messages from Hennessy while I'm in bed with Suge White over there.
Listen.
And you know what I mean? Who the fuck is texting you right now? Babe, it's Hen. It's Hen. He's a night owl.
I'm a night owl. I'm saying, like, niggas got to let me know if you don't need me to text you at some time. You know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to get you in trouble. I just trying to relay some information.
Yeah, hey, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Let's keep that on regular business hours.
Me.
So I don't wake up with a frying pan
right,
getting hit in my face.
I'm gonna make sure I text her that.
Motherfucking time.
Uh-huh. She's like, who's texting? I'm motherfucking time right now. Mm-hmm.
My bad, man. I ain't mean to get nobody in trouble.
Motherfucking time.
Shout out to I want to give a shout out to Connected Clothing.
Yeah,
as well.
Man.
Today is their 9-year anniversary.
Man, salute. Salute, big
12,
time.
12, 12, 12 is when they were established. Real dope clothing line organization, you know what I'm saying? Doing their work to, get parolees to, turn their life around, you know what I'm saying? Sacramento.
Well, that's tight.
Yeah, like outside of music, I know people that have been, that they've helped.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That before, they didn't even know about me knowing them or knowing Adam or anybody.
Yeah.
There's people that you bring it up. You know what I mean? I even see that shit. I seen the Connected stickers in Fairfield.
Hmm. Okay. I've been out of town and seen it, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a real movement, you know what I mean? So shout out to Adam, Tommy, and Dan. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man, my salute, people. Man.
Big salute to them.
Inspiration, for real.
Definitely. What else we got, man?
You dropped the album.
Oh, yeah, we did. Yeah.
How's that doing?
It's bussing. You know what I'm saying? It's doing I've been some slapping. Right now.
I've been slapping. I see you picked one of my favorite joints tonight.
I did mm-hmm. that on purpose. Yeah. Dropped
that
the
motherfucker,
bomb.
Yeah.
That's
boom.
Right.
Boom. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. No. No, yeah, that, yeah, hey, that
sounds like you started punching somebody.
That shit, but hey, Simo, you said you got an album coming though, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, yes, I do. It's actually up for pre-order on Christmas, but it's not going to drop, until January 21st, though. You know, I'm kicking the year off with just dropping albums every month. You know what I'm saying?
It's going to be cool. How many tracks?
It's going to be different. It's going to be different every time. This one right now is going to be a 4-track album. You know what I'm saying? Remember we was having a conversation about
EPs,
like...
Right.
Yeah. Fuck it, it's an album. Everything I'm dropping is an album. If I got more than one song, then it's a fucking album.
That's nice.
Every fucking time. But it's going to have 4 tracks on it. It's going to have 2 songs that are instrumentals, and then the next 2 songs that complete the album is they're bonus tracks for those instrumentals. You know what I'm saying?
Dope. And it's got people rapping on them shit?
It's going to be one particular artist every time.
Nice.
So it's going to be like... So it's called The GOAT. It's an acronym for The Greatest of All Tapes.
Okay.
Shout out to DJ like, Fresh, because it's like Cincinnati shit, okay, though, So it's going to be like...
That's real.
The Greatest of All Tapes with Dolly Unknown. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and each person's featuring.
I need one now. Now that we having that conversation about different artists being featuring, I think you need to tap into the whole thing.
For sure. That shit about to be tight, bro. But pre-order on Christmas, man.
All right, man, on all digital shit, like
everything.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay. I did a cypher in Vegas recently, and that's dropping on Christmas. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my brother Mighty Bush, but drop on YouTube and a couple other places.
Mighty the Monster and shit.
You know what I'm saying? And then I got a video I'm dropping with Alize Ali on New Year's Eve. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Is that the one I seen?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That shit's wet.
We gonna start the year off right.
Yeah.
Well, we got this Council Culture album.
When is that dropping? It dropped Friday.
Oh, okay, Sal.
Yeah, yeah. He's okay. It dropped Friday, so he's been pushing it, doing it. You know what I mean? Shouts out to the man Highway. If you ain't check that out, go pick it up. You know, he's a monster. That's part of one of my clique homies. You know what I'm saying? But then you know, I always still go check out that Humphrey Dogart. You know what I'm saying? Yes. Anywhere you get that digital shit.
You need that, in, with your, that. In your collection.
Y'all don't know Doe really dope.
And then I'm thinking about doing, I already got the next album planned out too. I think it's going to be a little something like some rap shit and some R&B shit.
So yeah.
Like a double tape or something. We going to see. But yeah, man, make sure you pick it up.
I miss double albums. I'm
old.
Come on, would you do like 3-minute songs?
Nah. Yeah. Nah. Maybe.
Nah.
Hey, I was told like by like, you know what I'm saying, an OG in a game, like songs used to be like 4 minutes back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, what's wrong?
Oh, yeah,
with
three
it?
Verses.
Nothing's
every
wrong
song.
With it. I just, I'm
so okay. So
I think I started getting into music when like tracks are only like, you know, like damn near 3 minutes. You know, now it's like shorter than that.
So what do you prefer though? Like two verses in a hook?
I honestly don't think you should hold up to a standard. I mean, like hold it up to a standard, but don't like, you know, like be like, oh,
whatever,
I'm gonna keep
song
like
says.
This because it's like we're supposed to be like this, or you know, yeah. Like
I'm gonna say
know?
Everything that I need to say.
There's no
and
time
when I'm done saying yeah, what I need to say,
so there's no time.
Then the song is over.
You gonna do what I tell you to do?
You don't want to listen. To
I mean,
it,
no, though. But look, when like when we was working on the gas station, now there's four members. That's 4 16s. Gets to be like a 4 or 5 minute, 6 minute
lot,
song.
Unless you chop it up
with hooks
like,
in it. You know what I'm saying? Unless you put long ass verses in it.
Yeah, right.
Which is a little long, but still, though, that's what you want to do.
Then fucking do it.
Fuck them people out there. To
LV, what you think? What you think? Short, like you like more doing the shorter joints, longer joints.
It depends what's on my mind. So it's hard to really put a time limit on it. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
When you hit that booth and you really into it, there's no telling how long it might take you to get it done.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying, or to finish.
Yeah, some songs will write themselves, right, and the other songs might gotta work at that
some
motherfucker.
Time,
yeah,
that's right.
Like I said, nigga. Say everything you gotta say.
That's no time limit. You
know, whatever that is, and then we done.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So yeah, man. Go get that Council Culture album.
Yeah.
Go get that Humphrey Dogart album.
Get that 316
album.
And look out for that. What's the name of the album, Racy?
The GOAT.
The
greatest of all tapes.
I smoke too much weed, my
but I mean, you know, you
who's
look feet, up
who's this
GOAT?
One though? Who's this one feet?
Yum's Awkward.
Yum. Okay. Yum. Yeah, he gets down. I remember dude from coming to the bars. The bars.
Yeah, that's exactly how I met. I mean, I already knew of him, but then when he started coming and he was like coming and rapping and shit,
yeah.
Like I was
yeah,
like,
he gets down. I remember OG tried to come at him on some battle shit, and he came back. Like the young boy came back.
Shout out Yums, man. We got to get Yums.
Shout
on
out
the
Uptown
show.
Too, man.
Yeah,
y'all
man.
Go fuck with them rib tips, bro.
Uptown, the home of hip hop. You know what I'm saying? And,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Underground hip hop is thriving.
Speaking of which, man, next this Friday, Uptown Vibes. The performances are Saab Halo, Q Stunner, HK the One, Chazzo, The Bishop, SOLO, KTP,
y'all
The Game.
Streaming, y'all streaming.
Y'all
check that out.
Extra credits.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
Go check that out, man.
7
shit,
to 10.
Like culture.
2306 Oxford Street is the address.
Really,
man,
what I feel about it too, like when I first went with her, like it's like culture, like you're tapping in, like this is like some shit that like was like in Detroit what they had at that little spot that they went to. You know what I'm saying? If that's what it feels like, you know what I mean? Like you bump in there, anybody there, it's super chill. You lay back and kicking, you know what I mean?
Smoking.
You ever been to Soul Collective?
Nah.
It's like, it was like some indoor, like open mic type of, you know, people get to perform type of shit.
Yeah.
You know, but like, that was like, you know, a couple years back.
Yeah.
Know? So how I see it, it's like something like that. You know,
I like that
it
shit.
It was dope. They had the hater screen where you could, where the motherfuckers was performing and doing their open mic, and behind them was a screen, and you could text into this number. And say whatever the fuck you wanted to say.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, I bet that got
like
ugly, though.
On the screen.
And you,
if you turn around, you can
see
it. See
that,
that's a self-esteem
come
killer
on.
Instantly.
Uh-huh. Or, you can, or if you're freestyling, you might come up with a bar off it. Or, you know what I mean?
Right. Flip that whole shit. But, uh-huh. I mean, you know, the idea is to not look at the screen because it's going to take you out your element. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I thought it was a dope little addition to what they was doing. Shout out to Andrew Defy, man. You know what I'm saying? That was doing that back in
that's
the day.
That's dope.
And shout out to the whole city, man. Anybody out here working, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
We see it, and we appreciate it because it gives us content to play, you know what I mean? So with that being said, I think we should get into some
play
music.
Some motherfucking content.
Right. Let's go. Let's start it off with Darion, man. The name of the record is Tony. This is exclusive. This ain't even
what?
Out like that.
What?
Hey, I told him, keep that shit. Tied. We wear that shit the whole time, bro. I'm telling you.
Let's get into it, though, man. A whole lot more music on the way. It's called
Tony. It's like the last one in the,
yeah,
in the
yeah.
list.
It's Darion, right?
We jumped it up.
Okay.
30 seconds. You're tuned in to Late Night Love, and this is Humphrey Dogart. Make sure, you know, you call in and give your honey something sweet. Let her know you care about her. We're playing slow jams all night long. You know, I'm working on that. In case this job don't work out, I might try to go to one of these late night stations.
Oh, damn, shit.
Yeah.
Face on the beat.
I had to make some sacrifices to rock these diamonds and gold. Really what? Had to hit the road and really stay on my toes and get in that mode like a pit bull bite down. Had to risk it all on God just for this lifestyle. And I'm no stranger to pressure. I was grinding, I was trying to blind, you know, straight pressure. In the streets, gotta stay careful. Niggas watching and they plotting the poppers, you really can't help us. These niggas pussy and change on their brothers. What? I knew you was a bitch, the son of your mother. You know. And it's time you get exposed and come undercover. See, you see me out here shining, I never was sunny. Thought I ran with big time, it's the way I be stunning. Bitch, I came from the gutter, I'm really from nothing. All that pressure made a diamond determined to something. When I made my first 100, I made me another. Doing 100 miles and running, I'm feeling like Usain. Bitch, I caught the wave, I need me a Moosain. Don't do games or hang with no lames. I'm double low gang on holy, I won't change. And it's within this, this is the business. Niggas play, they get popped and put on the hit list. Hey, Lord is my witness, hustle's relentless. I can't stop till the empire big, tremendous. On my grind like Tony. Ain't no a nigga dope like Ayo. Bitch, on the plug like Tony. I hawk a nigga down like Tony. Got it from the mud like Tony. I get no fuck like Tony. And I don't really trust like Tony. Cause niggas be faking, be phony. This why I be by my lonely. I barely got time for the homies. Never know when niggas plotting to get on me. Hey, my Luodi stay with a 40. He be shooting like Ginobili. He play, he'll blow ya. He be ducking like the Rosen. He play exposure. I be really out here trapping them, getting them bows in. Niggas tried to backdoor me, I'm closing them doors in. No matter dog, I'm God, I'm going in. Ball, I'm spalled in. Life is a gamble, well, I'm all in. Since a youngin', I've been standing alone and chalking like a mermaid. I fend for myself a dolphin. Hey, no ballerina, had to stay on my toes. I'm double low, I never changing my bros. Never changing my woes. These niggas pussy, we gon' get him exposed. A trendsetter, I've been setting the tone. A go getter, you know. A young nigga shining like a diamond dude. Fly nigga stunt, that's for grinding do. One of them niggas in the north, I be mobbing too. Down grand with them bands, I be mobbing through. For my goonies and my mama do. Touch a B before I die, that's what I'ma do. And I'm never going broke, bitch, I promise you. Feel like Tony with them birds, how they flying through. Let's talk about it. You know, I be on my quiet shit, trying to be humble and shit. But you know, fuck that, nigga, let's turn up. Let's talk about it.
You better start respecting
something. Like I ain't one of them flatland niggas out here having in my way. Let's talk about it. Like I ain't been a nigga who set the tone and made you niggas wanna put that shit on. Like I ain't made niggas wanna get up and you feel me and do they thing, nigga, really get to it. Yeah.
What?
Nigga, the motivation
what?
For real, nigga.
What?
Double O.
Yeah. That's what up. Whoa. What up, go? Yeah.
Scarlet
Music.
What's on your mind, girl?
What's on your mind, girl?
Just you and me.
Hey. What's on your mind? How you really feel about it? Past and present, baby, bringing me balance. Soaring high in the sky with no intention of landing. My understandings, I'll never take it for granted. Watch it grow, I mean the seed that we planted. If I lost everything, I only need you on this planet. Hey.
I mean, tell me what you need from me.
Tell me what you need from me.
I could do it easily. You're worth it, you're worth it to me. I can show you what the heavens be.
And I say if we on the ground, yeah, she take me to the clouds. With my ego get too high, yeah, she knock it back down. I put my heart in the sound. In these flows, I'ma drown. Back to the surface from the depths of the underground. I'm so profound.
What's on your mind, girl?
What's on your mind, girl?
And can I get a little of your time now?
A little of your time now?
It
it could be you and me flying out.
We flying out.
Live a little bit and let your wings spread out.
Now let your wings spread out.
It's just you and me flying out.
We flying out. We flying out.
It's just you and me flying out.
We flying out. We flying out.
Yeah, it's just you and me. It's just you and me. Tay Tay ging ging off off straight straight flying. Three three two two one one we're tay tay ging ging off off straight straight soaring.
Soaring, soaring, soaring.
Three two one we're taking off straight flying. What's on your mind, girl?
What's on your mind, girl?
Shelf Radio. That was KO. Yeah, kind of odd. Soarin' is the name of that record.
Mm-hmm.
Real so dope record, man.
That's the one with the bike, the bikes in the video,
that's,
right?
No, that's Ride 2.
That's Ride 2.
Nah, he ain't did a video for this. Oh, yeah, but the single tight. Is available, though.
I went to that event that day. It was tight.
Okay. Yeah, I like that whole culture. I'm feeling that whole culture.
Shout out my Skylit music family, man. Tap in with each and every member of the team. It's a whole lot of talent. You know what I mean? So, yeah, shout out, man. And right before that, we started off with Darion. Tony is the name of that record. That video is actually
shout out to my bro Space too, because he produced that. That's my motherfucking dog.
There you go.
Shout out Space, man.
We gotta get Space back on the show, man. Dope individual, man.
Go like them videos, go like them joints, man.
Run
share
them
shit.
Views up, run them streams up, all that shit, man. We encourage y'all to
if
do
you
all
tuning
of that.
In, go share this shit too. We'll tell right. you people to get on this too. Come right. on.
Let them know Top Shelf Radio is on, man. You know what I'm saying? Oh, you got some news for these
yeah,
people?
Yeah, Eddie,
I got some news.
Let's
some
get into some news.
Okay.
Entertainment. N-E-W-S. News.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
N-E-W-S.
News. And that's the sounds, ladies and gentlemen. That's how you hear it. Today's news is once again being brought to you by Hendo with a twist of Simo, cultivated in Northern California with only the finest ingredients from the underground.
Sir.
You know how we do it. We're going to get right into it, y'all. LL Cool J has been honored with his own statue in Queens. Soundbite one, Eddie. Dead air.
They call me Big L.A. Big Silly.
Let's go.
Hey, that motherfucker.
LL doing it. James Todd Smith, better known as LL Cool J, has evolved from a skinny little kid from Queens to a vicious MC at Def Jam Records and a brute force in all areas of entertainment. The legendary rapper's hometown has honored him with a new statue created in his likeness. The statue features a replica of the famous boombox LL put on his album cover, complete with a cassette version of the rapper's debut, Ready to Go. Number two, Eddie. That's for that old school. On other news, LL was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame this past October. So shouts out to the man. Start paving the way for a lot of us artists out there. You know what I mean? So
any hip hop artist that could get indicted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, I salute them all, man.
That's tight.
Nice.
That means you're really hardcore,
right?
That mean, yeah, I guess because. I'm bad. No muscle bound man. I can't do all that. Hey, so look, is it a good idea to make a Christmas song? Eddie, number three.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way.
What?
Look, every December, every December of every year, Mariah Carey makes $1 million off royalty from her hit song, All I Want Is for Christmas Is You. Number four, Eddie.
Make my wish
come. A million. Another mil.
Right.
Imagine every December, no matter what. She ain't put music out since when?
Years.
Uh-huh.
She ain't got to. Get the mil every Christmas. Come on.
Go ahead, Mariah. Yeah. Hey, proving that you can strike Christmas gold with a hit record.
Come on.
That can make Christmas real special for your family for years to come. Other notable Xmas Christmas songs are, you know, the homie Jameezy Baby has Santa Is the Homie. Number five. He just put this out. So he's on to it.
You know me. Just rapping in the big
boy. Uh-huh. Hey, it's the homie.
Shout out that man.
Uh-huh, that man, a friend of the show. Christmas in Hollis by Run DMC, sound by six.
Santa was at the trap.
It was December 24th on Hollis Avenue.
Uh-huh. If you don't know about this, you ain't.
I don't know this song, but it's tight, though.
You never heard this?
Hell nah.
Except for you that young? Come on, man, it's classic. Hey, look. And did everybody know, too, the breakout song for Outkast, Player's Ball, was actually featured on a Christmas album compilation.
Yeah, because they
So let me get Sound Bit Sunday. That was on a Christmas album. That's what made them blow. If you listen to the lyrics, too, they talking about Christmas. That's when the Player's Ball happened, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. All right, and last but not least, because we keeping it short and sweet on the
can
news.
Can we answer that question though? Is it a good idea?
Is it? Let's run it around.
Hell fucking yeah!
You think so?
Yeah, I'm trying to tap into that holiday.
So you just heard a new one, right? You was talking about
it. Oh, fucking Jimmy Fallon, Ariana Grande, Megan Thee Stallion.
Uh huh.
No bullshit.
A Christmas joint. He said I can't get it out of my head.
Jamming. That nigga talk about standing in line to get a booster shot. Yeah. But it's flipped though.
But
go check the shit out. You know what I'm saying?
Did Mighty and Van Glorious too? They did a little Christmas. Brulee. And yeah, Brulee did a Christmas. What you think about it, Simo? You ever make a Christmas joint?
Yeah, fuck on, yeah.
Yeah.
I was stuck in dark because I was like, damn, who could I hit to make a Christmas song? I'm over here thinking a beat right now. In my head, I'm over here like, damn.
LV, what you think?
How I'm gonna make it?
You making a Christmas joint in your repertoire?
Stop playing. You already know. Yeah.
If the beat there, you already know. You got the beat. I got the heat.
Yeah. Okay. That's
man,
a real,
I'm coming like
that's
this.
A real
I'm
rapper go, right there. Oh, you can't have a DJ in the booth without him throwing shit in.
That's how I'm coming.
Hey, so and we wrapping. Last but not least, a cannabis company created an 850-pound edible believed to be the world's largest weed brownie. Soundbite number eight, Eddie.
What's your emergency?
A van. Help me, a van.
That'd be me.
My heart's beating backwards.
What makes you think your heart's beating backwards?
Well, normally it goes goof, boop, and now it's going boop, goop.
Are you having any other symptoms?
I can see sounds. I can hear colors. I forgot my shit.
Sir, have you taken any illegal substances?
No, I just ate a brownie that a drug addict gave me, but that ain't got nothing to do with my emergency.
And what's your emergency, sir?
I measured my butt crack three times. It was longer each time. I'm splitting into two people. There's like 17 more brownies on that plate. I'm gonna finish them off and call you back.
911, what's your emergency?
Weed Ratchet in Massachusetts, a Massachusetts-based cannabis company celebrated National Brownie Day by unveiling what it claims to be the largest THC-infused brownie ever made to promote the launch of its new brand, Bubby's Baked Marimed Incorporated. They took to Twitter to reveal the massive tree, which weighs a massive 850 pounds. It measures 3 feet by 3 feet and contains 20,000 milligrams of THC.
Come on.
How do y'all feel about edibles, though?
It's unnecessary.
Look, check it out, man. You can't eat too many of them motherfuckers.
I had a bad experience.
850 pounds? Why?
Why?
Why did you?
Nah, I'm pretty sure they're probably breaking it up, though.
Nah,
it's one. Man. Not one person can. You can't eat that. There's no way. But I'm saying.
So why make it?
I don't just to make
why
it.
Why you couldn't make?
You just got that much weed. You don't care about like just hella shake laying around. Mad pounds of shake laying around. Or I don't know.
don't know.
Why you would do that. So look,
talk about your battery.
So we came. I came and did the show here when I started promoting Humphrey, and Eddie gave me one that he got from Katie.
And fucking, hey man, be okay. safe.
So look, it was just a Cheeto, and they said like, take it easy, like only eat half. So we ate. I ate half.
A regular size Cheeto,
like a Cheeto, like a regular Cheeto puff, right? Yeah. I ate half. I'm like, me and her chilling. I'm like, I'm writing, freestyling everything. Like, I'm just rapping. You know what I mean? Like, good, right? Day goes by. Next day, we about to go somewhere we couldn't smoke. And it was going to be a minute before we could smoke. You know what I mean? So I knew something was coming up. And I had a meeting later that day with my media guy from my music. And I said, fuck, I'm going to eat a whole one. It was like 8 o'clock. Zapped.
Bad.
Done, bro. Done. We went to the store, and she's like, "Go get me a pack of cigarettes." I couldn't talk. I couldn't, bro. I never get paranoid. I've been smoking weed since eighth grade, bro. I never get paranoid. I'm not going to that store right now, babe. I can't do it right now. There's something going on. Like we was supposed to stop by the store, and on the way home, we took three different ways. Like, you know, you're headed home. And then we were supposed to go to the store, so then we took the turn. No, she was driving. Okay. So we took the turn to go home. Then we go there. Oh, wait. Then we got back out. Three times we did that. Then got back to the house. Then went to the store. Then my dude calls me. He's like, hey, we're talking. You got all stuff.
Ate a Cheeto too?
We're talking business. Oh, she ate a half, though. We're supposed to talk business about like all my whole marketing layout, everything, right? I have all these notes. I can't say a word, bro.
He's like,
like the super. I was so embarrassed of myself, like super unprofessional and shit. But just it was a bad, bad experience, bro. I was like, dude, I measured my butt crack. It keeps getting longer. I'm sweating it too.
I got a question. I got a question for everybody. What do y'all? What appropriate age y'all think it is okay for y'all to start smoking weed? I mean, of course, we're talking about like the next you coming along.
I can't say anything.
I mean, like, because and when did y'all start smoking weed?
Me, I started smoking weed eighth grade summer.
But on some sneaky shit though, or like you was like, hey dad, hey mom, I'm smoking weed. What's up?
Never, never. I would have died.
So you was sneaking that shit.
I show up. I come in with my eyes bloodshot, and mom swore I was high.
Look, my little brother got caught smoking weed at school. Almost got expelled. Okay, I'm the first one that got him high. We would come home. We just smoked together. My mom would never look at me. I'm in the fridge grabbing frozen shit, just eating everything I can. She's yelling at him because his eyes is barely red. Like, no, I was smooth with it, bro. Like, I got never got caught.
You say you was in the fridge grabbing frozen
shit? Yeah, like eating like frozen lasagna, you know what I mean? Like, whatever.
The fridge getting the frozen
just whatever. Hella old leftovers and shit. If that shit ain't got mold, then we good, right? So, I mean, just
shit.
Yeah.
Okay, so I had a bad experience too, and I would never fuck with that shit publicly again. I went to, it was the Cannabis Cup or whatever they had at Cal Expo.
Mm-hmm.
And so we was walking around and, you know, everybody dabbing and shit, you know what I'm saying? And you know, I don't fuck around with edibles like that because I know how they do me. So I walked up into a booth and one of the homies was there. And I had smoke, you know what I'm saying? So I had cotton mouth. He was like, hey, man, you want one of these punches? You know what I'm saying? I said, hell yeah, I want one of them motherfucking punches.
And a little syrup?
I ain't know. That shit out there, I thought that shit was tropical punch, you know what I'm saying? They gave me a big ass glass. I was like, man, that's love. He ain't charged me more than nothing. I'm sipping on this shit as I walk around. Like, damn, this the best fucking punch I ever had in my life.
Motherfucking
I drank the fuck out there. I'm telling you, that shit was tall, too. A big ass punch.
I drank the fuck out of that.
I was thirsty as shit, you know what I'm saying?
Oh my God.
Man, I don't know how many minutes went by, but all of a sudden, nigga, I was like, nigga, I need to sit down. And sitting down in the chair went from sitting up to like my arms was flailed over the side. I'm laying in the middle of this fucking cannabis cup. Niggas is walking by looking at me crazy.
Are you okay?
I'm done. No, I'm not okay. You know what I'm saying? I want to go home. I was so high. I said I gotta get out of here because I can't be here. I'm way too high. I don't know. I still didn't put two plus two that was in the drink. But you know what I'm saying, eventually I did. But I went out to the car, thought I was finna drive home. I had to call my wife. I was like, you got to come and pick me up from this place. I'm too
done.
High.
Zap, bro.
It's
that's
bad.
The only way I could put it.
It's bad
I could.
Right
I
now.
Like, bro. I've smoked for my whole life. Yeah. Damn it. Like, you know what I mean? Probably the better half of my life. I've never been that high, bro.
Yeah, I was higher than
never,
that.
Never, bro.
And I'm not trusting any drinks that somebody randomly give me. I'm going to ask, what's
you
in that
motherfucker? You ain't had no bad experience, Timo?
I had a couple.
You trying to forget about
it. Nah, the most recent one, I ain't gonna lie, the most recent one, I got some edibles from Katie. And they be fire all
she
the time.
She supposed to come up here and bring us some edibles tonight.
It was fire. Hey, I think they were like the little the mini ropes.
It tastes like real too.
I dogged all of them. I was like, fuck it, they're hella good. I'm dogging all of them. I ate all of them.
Taste don't no smoke weed before you
I was already smoking. I was smoking all day. I was smoking all day.
The worst part about it is it hits me out of nowhere, right? Like if you smoke, if I'm smoking this, I'm smoking a joint, a blunt, whatever. I know I'm getting lit.
Monitoring your
bruh, intake. 5 minutes later, I'm walking.
I had to change, bro. I had to put shorts on. I walked around the house with no shirt on. I swear to God, I was hot. I was sweating, but I was lit. I laid down on the couch because I started feeling like my heartbeat in my neck. It was hella weird. I was like, bro, I got to slow down. I laid down. I fell asleep. Bad. I think I woke up at like 3 o'clock in the morning. I was like, damn, I ain't never eating one of those again. Fuck never all again. That.
Never again. Yeah.
Fuck shout out to Katie though, because she be.
Yeah.
You know
shout
saying.
Out to Katie. She said, "I told you to be careful." Eddie told you to be careful. I said, "Yeah, y'all did." I thought I was trying to be cool. Yeah.
trying to
be cool. I could take it.
No,
I could do it. Now. I ain't doing nothing.
She'd be like, "You don't want to eat this right now."
That should be my ass.
To eat that one in the process of laying down when I'm already in
for
bed.
For real.
Got shit else to do.
That's it. Melting to the bed.
I'm cool.
That's a done.
You don't want to be in public.
But that's it for the news, man. That's you know what I mean. Let's just keep it light.
Okay. Let's get into this keep it in rotation segment, man. We got a new challenger.
That's why I told her to open the door, bro. It's hot as fuck.
It is fucking. We need a fan.
I'm running hot, bro. Open that bitch all the way towel, like it was.
I'm still sweating.
Bacon.
Come on.
Hey, Eddie, just fucking sound by nine.
He's like,
Eddie.
Fuck, you beat us hot.
So, yeah, let's get into this.
911, what's your emergency?
I finished all them brownies.
Sir,
I finished all them brownies.
And I'm real glad I called. I got an emergency, all right, because I just realized that my body's a haunted house. Because inside, a haunted house. There's a skeleton, a ghost, and blood and shit all over the walls.
Fucking shit.
How many brownies did you eat, sir?
Well, I either ate Glorn Blumium or Glorn Plumblumium.
What?
But Fartlalong and Slop.
Are those supposed to be numbers, sir?
Guess and bobbin.
Is that supposed to be a yes, sir?
Pleel bloop.
Sir, I think your brain broke.
Watch out for the edibles, kids.
Blish and bloop, mayonnaise, back scratch, a crouton, flarp.
Goodbye, sir.
I don't care if you are. Don't try to prove something.
Right.
With
right.
an edible.
Be hanging with the wrong person who eat that shit like it's candy.
Hey, you fuck with these? Yeah, hell yeah, I do.
Suck your chest back in, nigga. Though. You ain't got the stuff.
I had somebody tell me that their eyes were sweating off of edibles. My eyes are sweaty.
Yeah.
I can hear myself breathing. Calm
that
down, bro.
Heavy,
sit down.
Man.
Take it easy.
No lie.
Keeping it in rotation, though, we got a
new challenger.
IBJB's going for 3 weeks in a row.
I'm trying to get it, man.
Uh-huh.
Crazy. What you need? You say you need 4 or 5?
Six to retire?
Yeah. 6 weeks in a row.
And he already did that once, right?
He did. Just the last go-round.
I fucks with him.
Shout out IBJB, man. Dope-ass artist. But we got a new challenger we finna play first before we get into it. He go by the name of Germ Deezy.
Germ Dizzle. Shout out to Germ, man.
Shout out Germ, man.
My cousin introduced me to him. Shout out Smeez, too.
Germ is a dope artist, you know what I'm saying?
He's tough.
And so he got a record called Vibe Island. I was actually at a little house party thing that he threw not too long ago, and he performed it.
I'm an island boy.
So what is that?
Boy.
Where can I find that? He's like, I'm going to send it to you. Bet. So
all right, real quick, too. Shout out Virgo Glow, Slapjaw, BTC JDZ. And IBJB, they tuned in on the live on the
on YouTube. Island boy.
Okay. That's grandma, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Shout out grandma. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, let's get into this.
We gonna challenge it first? Vibe Germ Deezy.
Yeah, let's go.
I'm on fuck time.
So look, we're gonna ask y'all to tune in on like which one to pick this song or the next one. So.
Welcome to my island. Oh, it's been a while. Even though you tripping, I just wanna see you smiling. I love it when we violent. We gotta stay silent, they gon' try to divide us. I'm just tryna guide us. Touches like the Midas. Everything is gold, reflection turning to stone. I love you, nobody knows. My soul is bigger than yours, yeah. And since you left, at best, I feel alone, yeah. Hey, and when I think of all the nights that I stayed up, every trip ain't feeling right if I ain't got my baby. Take a drag slow, there ain't no need to be hasty. Keep it on the low, and I don't get finna play me. Hey, and I know you never fold. I know that you gon' make it, you can get it on your own. These niggas, they be faking, they love you, they want a bone. I think that it's funny when you tell me I'm living wrong. But please
just don't go back to your planet, I need you. I hate when I don't understand and mislead you. I drew a line all the time and you crossed it. When I lost you, girl, I swear I lost it. Welcome to my island, know it's been a while. Even though you tripping, I just wanna see you smiling. I love it when we violent, we gotta stay silent. They gon' try to divide us, I'm just tryna guide us. Welcome to my island, know it's been a while. Even though you tripping, I just wanna see you smiling. I love it when we violent, we gotta stay silent. They gon' try to divide us, I'm just tryna guide us. Yeah, yeah, never let you change me. I started my mission when niggas was turning 18. We started prevailing and sailing across the gray sea. You started detailing the prophecy that awaits me. And I love what you believe. I love it when you tell me to hold you and never leave. I let you do your thing, cause that pain I wanna relieve. The nights that you grieve, blood on your sleeves. Baby, get beneath, know you need some sleep. Quit being naive, you know what you can achieve. And it used to be my pee, my love growing on receipt. Got me feeling incomplete, I don't even wanna breathe, yeah. Welcome to my island, know it's been a while. Even though you tripping, I just wanna see you smiling. I love it when we violent, we gotta stay silent. They gon' try to divide us, I'm just tryna guide us. Welcome to my island, know it's been a while. Even though you tripping, I just wanna see you smiling. I love it when we violent, we gotta stay silent. They gon' try to divide us, I'm just tryna guide us.
Top Shelf Radio. That was the Keeping in Rotation Challenger right there. Germ Deezy is his name.
That's a vibe.
Vibe Island is the name of that record. You know what I'm saying?
And the name fits it.
Right. It was a vibe. You know what I'm saying? See what he gonna do up against JB, though. You know what I'm saying? JB is the person to beat right now. You know what I mean?
JB knows how to make a hit.
He do, man. So we gonna see how I do, man. The name of his record is Blame You. Features IB Hitter. And it's going for 3 weeks, man. We're going to see if it happens.
Let's see if he going to stay there.
Shout out JB, man, for
the champ is here.
Continuously bow, 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 sending in music.
Hey, any fucks with the...
Came here to ball out, no doubt. It's...
No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is. No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is.
It's true, nobody can put the blame on you. For wanting me, probably because of the things I do. I'm independently blessed like a sneeze I chew. Forever holding it down like the strings on shoes. How the fuck can I lose if I'm focused up on my cream? The way you focused on me, I can tell you like what you see. You been fucking with these jokers, it's time to get with the king. And I make you feel like a queen when I get you up out them jeans. With my team, yo, pass me the fifth. Sacramento back in the mix, and I'm that nigga cracking the whip. I've been clocking like the watch on my wrist. I got this chick twerking the hips. Imagine what she do to a dick. Know what she doing, keep it moving, get to popping it quick. I got the fluid, got the swag to make your girl wanna dip. So I pursue to break her off some of this real nigga dick. And when I'm through, I kick her out and then that bitch wanna trip. I tell her.
No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is. No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is.
Came through 2 a.m., but I can't blame you. It's all on the deuce, say plus I'm smoked out. We can do what you wanna do, baby. No stress, lay that pussy to rest. I'm like a dino bishop, just pick up the phone. When I tap in, you tap out, the feeling is strong. No cuffing, just fucking, listening in the moment. rolling in this blunt after blunt. Probably write me some songs. It's all boss, nigga. The leader on my team, nigga. West Coast bad bitches do the most, nigga. Chronic smoking, blowing O's. Double D's, holla those. Mr. Bartender, please, can you run it up? And tell the DJ to turn this motherfucker up. From the club to the car, from the car to the crib to the bed. We fuck him, check up the deuce on
my. No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is. No, I can't even blame you. I feel the same too. But your body language is dangerous. That's what the blame is.
Top Shelf Radio. That it right there was IBJB.
Rotation.
IB Hitter is on that record as well.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Sparky up in the watching the YouTube, man. Shout out Sparky.
Okay.
Sparky made a slap, man. He really a goat. Okay. He's really a goat. Really a young legend coming up, man.
Shout out Sparky, man.
For sure. For sure.
Shout out JB and IB Hitter, though. You know what I'm saying? Yep. That record right there is dope. You know what I'm saying?
Jerm Deezy.
Right there.
Hard one to beat, but we gonna see how the people feel.
You know, hey, can I tell y'all how I met JB?
Yeah, let's hear it.
I used to work at FedEx in like 2012, and he was a security guard.
Okay,
that's exactly how I met him. And then like we ran into each other like later on, like recently. I was like, bro, I know you from somewhere, bro. And then it finally clicked. I seen him again. I was like, bro, he was a security guard at the what you call it? It's tight. Dope. He been tight ever since I met him.
Right.
He hella tight.
Not that man.
That's that man.
It's time to make a decision, though.
Uh-huh.
What we gonna do, man? We gonna go with the challenger, Jerm Deezy with the Vibe Island.
The Vibe Island.
We're gonna go with IBJB and IB Hitter with this Blame You.
You ain't starting with me this week.
Okay, we can start over there. I'm done with that.
I'm done with going first, bro.
No one going first. Fanny, how you feel?
Oh, we put Fanny.
We gotta start with one song.
We're both good, but I'm gonna stick with Blame You.
Okay, Blame You.
She fucks with IBJB.
There you go.
Yeah, the first song had a cool vibe. It really did, but the second one was
slapping.
So
that's two.
Okay, number two. That's two for two.
I need a pen.
So number one.
Number one. Okay. So you like the Vibe Island by Jerm Deezy?
Okay. For sure.
So.
Before this one.
Okay.
So the first number one. Vibe Island. Okay. The young cats fuck with Jerm Deezy. You know what I mean?
Jerm Deezy make music for the young cats.
LV.
Right.
I like Blame You.
Okay. Blame You. So that's.
Yeah, I like that.
Okay.
That's three Blunt Muse.
Yep. I'm going with the champ, man. I'm going with the champ this week.
Try to vote him out twice.
I like the Bobby. I try to vote him out. I just was feeling.
I be taking that shit personal. I'm still mad at you.
What happened?
Best Schemo didn't pick my song over IBJB, too.
When?
IBJB beat me because of.
That song Tap Out is one hell of a song.
Yeah,
bro.
That's raw. Like undeniable. Undeniable.
I'm telling you, he was chewing. That song is so hard, bro. Hey, that song is hella hard. Nah. I know that song by heart. When I first heard it, I never stopped listening to it.
Yeah, that's
point.
A joint. That's a slap.
I'm not finna be biased. I'm not finna, you know what I'm saying? Just because I know somebody, I'm not finna pick that shit. Like, it just depends on my mood, how I'm feeling for the time being. And that song I was feeling a little bit more. But this week though, he did that. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so that's
champ.
Four for IBJB, two for Yums. What are you picking?
JB. Yeah.
And like Jerm, so that's five.
Five.
I like the Jerm Deezy joint, but like always, like the production value, that's always one of the things I go for. So IBJB.
That's six.
We got on the YouTube.
Okay.
Damn. Ask you guys. Hell,
Blame You. Virgo Glow said Blame You.
Okay.
That's another one. Bianca B.
Definitely Blame You.
Yep.
Yeah.
JDZ said one. Number one.
Okay, so that's.
That's three.
Do we even need to go to Eddie and put him on the spot?
It's always good to get his professional opinion.
Let's hear it from our resident DJ, Eddie Z.
There you go.
IBJB.
That's another one. There you go.
Total package. That's what I said. The man just knows how to make a song, and he got the mixing, the mastering, everything's there. You know what I mean? It's a good quality, so.
There you go.
I think we have a winner. You know what I'm saying? The champ remains the champ.
The champ is here.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm the champ, motherfucker.
Hey, anybody want to bet Dub that he going to retire this song?
Bet Dub?
I'm not finna bet against him.
Nah, I'll go find his song.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna bet against him. I'm not gonna bet against
him, nigga. You already said I tried to vote the nigga out. I ain't gonna bet against him. I hope he win. You know what I'm saying? I want to see you win.
Hey, but, shout out IBJB, man. But, like, big support of the show. Like, that's good shit, though. The song's dope, bro.
And shout out to Germ Deezy. Germ Deezy, man. Get down. Tap into that, man. He got some dope ass music. But what I do want to say is, I've had to pick the Keep It In Rotation songs, you know what I'm saying? And if people would send in music and let me know that they want to enter into this competition, then I wouldn't have to go randomly pick songs. So yeah, you artists out there ain't you know,
look,
you
official Top Shell Radio at gmail.com.
Send them bangs in.
Send in, and in the subject put Keep It In Rotation. If
my
you
question
want
is this, do they have to be released or they can be exclusive?
It can be exclusive, but remember, the mix, if the mix can make or break your song, though, right? Because a lot of the ways I judge is off the mix too, and the master.
Yeah.
So
but just,
if you send in something just that you just recorded on an app on your phone, compared to like an IBJB song, we gonna lose. Well, you know what I mean?
Be conscious of what you send in.
Yeah, send in some shit.
Very.
Don't
if you want to send something in, put your heart into it. Put the work into it. You
right.
know what I mean?
This is Top Shelf Radio. Yeah. I must remind
this ain't
y'all.
Bottom shelf.
This ain't no bottom
this
shelf.
This ain't
shit.
Top shelf life.
This ain't mid shelf.
Uh-huh.
So
smoke good, roll good,
shit.
Listen to good music.
All
you know
shit.
What I mean?
You know what I mean? So yeah. Official Top Shelf Radio at gmail.com. Send me your music, man. We need to hear it. You know what I'm saying? Send it right now. Stop what you're doing. Go to your email. Pick your song that you feel like it could, you know.
To me, send it in.
And send it in, man. You know what I'm saying? Or if you know a talented individual that's
official Top Shelf at Gmail.
Yep.
Official Top Shelf Radio, right?
Official Top Shelf Radio. Everything spelled right.
We got to get something to put up on the screen for it. Yeah. Produced by Pete Space, man. IBJB.
We're going to work on
it. The top of the shelf.
Shout out to both, contestants, though. You know what I'm saying?
The highest of shelves.
We definitely,
I got some mid shelf in the car.
No mid shelf.
Mid. That's Jules Verne. Jules Verne got the. I smoke mids, right? That nigga said he smoked mid grade weed. Ain't nothing wrong with it. Hey, we ain't judging, man. You smoke whatever you need.
It's some gelato for sure.
Smoke what you smoke.
As long as it do the job. I don't give a fuck what shelf it sits on.
Hey, I got a question. Can I ask a question real quick?
Let's do it.
Based off of, you know what I'm saying, the potency of the weed, right, and it's mid shelf and top shelf, if you still getting high, I mean, what the fuck is the point, right?
Hey, I don't even care what the name is.
Like, you're still getting high.
You're
not,
that to yourself.
You're not going
to
get more higher than what weed you smoking. You still get the same high whether you spend $80 or $30. It's the same high.
If it's the same,
the same one. Because you smoke two blunts, you're not going to get more higher.
I'm spending less. I'm trying to.
What the fuck you doing?
Like, yeah, no, I disagree, though. I disagree.
The flavor?
I can smoke two blunts of some whack shit.
What it look like?
But it looks good? What are you talking about? Or it's shitty? It's mid-shelf, okay? So we say top shelf when an eighth is like 60, 70 bucks, which probably.
Right.
Top
high.
Shelf, which is high as fuck.
Right.
I probably eat in the street. I don't go. But okay, so we say in that, opposed to an eighth that you get for 25, there's some.
No, we're not talking about that shit. We already know that shit.
What are you talking about?
No, we already know that shit.
We talking. So then, what's the mid?
So we're talking about the cannabis club, going to the dispensary.
Well, we talking about purchasing,
because I got my own thing going. We're going to spend
that
later.
But
we talking about purchasing from someone off the street.
I guess it's the same. If you want, I guess the quality, right?
There's THC content in the strain, though. Certain strains have more THC, certain strains have less.
So I guess you're just saying you're getting more higher than the mid shelf than the top shelf. Is that what it is? The high difference?
They put magic on that.
It tastes like candy. It smells good. It looks good. It gets you high too. You know, that's what I would consider top shelf. You know what I'm saying? I used to be a weed snob, bro. Like, I'm not smoking yours. I'm rolling my own. When I used to work at the little with the little company and I had it all day, like I had to pay for it. Yeah,
right.
I'm not smoking yours. I'm smoking my own. I promise you.
That bougie.
Hey, you want to hit the weed?
Nah.
Hey, when I first got with my girl, she a weed head, bro. She's like, yeah, it's okay. I'll roll something. I promise you, bro. But like to me, it's taste though. Like I like weed like that's why I always like a real good OG or something because I like the taste.
That was just an open question. I spend like $80. You know what I'm saying?
On an eighth,
I be buying weed.
Oh no, but not an eighth though.
It just depends. You know what I'm saying? It just depends how I'm feeling and if
the what your bank account look like.
I wouldn't necessarily say that. You know what I'm saying?
You better.
Would you spend $80 on an eighth? Any of you?
No. I have before.
Hell no.
I have before a few times.
Unless it's
for
just
sure,
like
sure.
I did on an accident.
What's the most moon rocks or whatever
that
is?
Like,
yeah, for sure.
On accident?
For sure.
No, he said he has.
Okay, I have spent 75
on
an eighth, but I was out of town. I 75 on an eighth in L.A.
Okay.
I did, but it was.
Okay. Ooh. Okay.
Yeah, that's where I spent $80. Yeah. I spent it in LA.
It was like, oh, I'm happy. I was telling happy. It was like my birthday. Okay. Yeah, sure,
yeah. We, y'all like Moon Rocks?
Yeah, I tried that shit.
I feel like it's overrated.
Dangerous game.
Explain it to him. It's a nug. The nug's rolled in oil, right? Mm-hmm. And then rolled in keef. The nug itself. Before you break it down and smoke it, that's how you get it. Right.
But you're not supposed to smoke though. You mix it with the weed you already broke down though. You don't smoke it.
It's flour.
I'm not trying to.
I mean, you can smoke it by
the whole nug.
Yeah.
You heard of ice caps? You ever heard of ice caps?
Hell yeah.
Okay, yeah. I do some work with them. So you could put that in there with no weed and smoke it because it's weed under there.
Yeah, it's
weird.
That's
fucked up. That's a cold
case. When you open it, you're going to see the weed.
The buzz inside.
That shit sounds like it's going to make you sweat when you call.
We sweat anyway.
It's a ride. It's a wild ride.
I can see sounds, man. I can see sounds.
It's a wild ride.
Yeah, I don't care, man. I think I don't have high standards.
I think once like the weed game became what it is, like motherfuckers started to try to do too much like crazy shit. Come on. Like,
does it do the job?
I'm going to do this. I'm gonna add this to it.
Does
I'm going to
do the job. Yeah. Keep the name to yourself. I don't care nothing about the mother details.
You're like, dude in Pineapple Express. You're Seth Rogen in Pineapple Express. Huh? I don't care just give me this, the good stuff right there. Looks good, smells good.
That's all I need. Uh-huh. That's all I need. It's not as, you know, my taste ain't as expensive as this Hennessy.
Speaking of, let me hit that.
That Hen Dog water.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. All right, let's play some music, man.
With a twist to see.
Play some music, and then we're going to come back. We're going to holler at LV and talk about everything you got going on.
We're getting this good interview.
Keep it locked, but let's go ahead and kick this segment off with
I'm excited about this. Big Sammy.
The name of the record is Happy Place, man. He's got some real dope music. I encourage y'all to check him out, so let's go ahead and kick that thing off, man.
Don't know what it is to have it all the time.
She moved, that smile genuine. Together we can't lose. She put it all on me, I bet it all on her. Take a chance, I never glance. These other chickens blurs. I see them come and go, you always stayed around. Been crushing on you since they played house. That's the dog pound. And as the years pass, we always kept in touch. Not every day, but when we seen each other, it was love. That's why I call you that. You always come with facts. Educated so you get it as we count these stacks. She a reflection of me, I'm just trying to make her smile. She all about her shmoney, me, I'm in the streets as wild. She do her, I do me. But when we together, yo, nothing else matters. It's just we gonna do the most. Bottles of bubbly, we toast, you feel the chemistry. I'm trying to harness up her energy. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place,
could be unhappy.
You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place,
hey yo.
The brain thinks, but the heart knows. Follow your gut, loved one. Trust the process and let it go. Just don't forget where you came from and how you got here. Don't forget about the people that will show up and cheer. If it wasn't for you, honestly, I'd disappear. You show me what genuine love looks like and now I fear. What would happen if I took action on how I feel? I'd be hurting you more than me just to keep it real. I gotta thank the fans out there that helped me clear my thoughts. All them DMs meant a lot, I wish they never stopped. Making music used to suck, the love is coming back. And you the only one that can take credit for all that. Margarita, tamarindo, bet the flavor's nice. She the entree, I'm on the side, yellow rice. Saffron until I'm gone and they love the spice. Get you a happy place to smile up your life. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place,
could be unhappy.
You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place, I got a couple of them. You got a happy place,
could be.
It's a bounce. It's a bop.
It's a bop.
It's a slap.
It's a slap. Come on.
It's a bounce.
Uh-huh.
It's a bop.
Yeah.
It's a slob.
Hey, nothing less fresher than a fucking bowl of fruit. Every day I'm fresh like I'm headed to a photo shoot. Admit it, I be fitted from my fitted to my kit. You ain't seen it so exquisite, got you tripping on my dreams. Talking big shit, cause I'm dipped like a bag of chips. Fresh zip, I be blowing like Gladys Knight in the pits. Hella lit, bitch, I feel like Hammer, I'm too legit. You should probably grab a camera, I'm on it, exclusive shit. I've been fresh so long, ain't no reason for me to quit. Drip game so strong, even Stevie could see the shit. Don't get it misunderstood, I spurs cause I'm getting money. Addicted to looking good, allergic to being bummy. Everything I got on was strategically formulated. I don't know why, but I feel the need to be coordinated. You couldn't be this fresh if you had a genie. Wet as a squeaky, that's how I'ma be whenever you see me. I'm fresh.
You've been fitted from my fitted to my kicks. With so much extra sauce, I can't help but drip. I ain't too much of a brother, but I'm sharper than a dagger. And I got so much swagger, I should sell that shit. Fresher than a fresh coat of paint on a wet fence. You can barely catch a glimpse from behind a fresh tint. Fresher than a fresh print, sucking on a breath. Ever since I got fresh, I ain't been less.
You could call me Dr. Dre, super saucy, or even Mr. Fresh. Cause I spit so cold, flow cool as an ice chest. Sick of the sideline, it's time and I'm next. So grab the scope, focus, I pass the eye test. Digest what I spit, I'm destined to shine. Like an unwanted pest infesting your mind. Grab the mic and it seems I freeze time. I hit the strip, fit on drip like squeeze lime. Looking clean and cleanse, feeling good and unique. I got some heat from Henny, cop the hoodie for speaks. Yo, I'm dressed to impress 7 days a week. So ask your mama, cause I probably look good when I sleep. I got a knack like Patty, you whack dog, go home. Fresh drip like a caddy, slam bagged and chrome. My rhyme scheme is clean, I spit bars obsessed. I didn't stutter, young brother, I'm fresh. I'm
super fly, hella fresh,
hella fresh.
Drip personified, in the flesh,
in the flesh.
Bitch, I'm bonafide, nothing less,
nothing less.
They don't turn me down, they always tell me yes. As I walk in, all the heads gon' spin. Like they back in 94 on some street well swims. Ain't no situation that I ain't gon' win. My fresh on 10.
Times 10.
Times 10.
I'm fresher than sushimi. Every single time you see me, I'm moving 4K like I'm on your fucking TV. Always on my grind behind the clothes that I design. Cause not only do I say it, but I wear what's on my mind. There's J's on my feet. Don't worry about my jeans. It's a pole in that bitch. And you know what I mean. Gucci doesn't suit me. I'm offended by your Fendi. And I'm over fashion over. All that shit too fucking trendy. I used to be a scrubby. Ain't nobody show me loving till I got it out the muddy. And now I'm fresher than Dougie. All year long I've been feeling unimpressed. Fuck 2020, I'm 2021 fresh. Obsessed with the way I drip. I got the haters tripping. I swear they must be rich. Look how they pay attention. Feeling real extra super happening. Yep, that's fresh. And I just spelled it out again.
Stupid fitted from my fitted to my kicks. With so much extra sauce, I can't help but drip. I ain't too much of a bragger, but I'm sharper than a dagger. And I got so much swagger, I should sell that shit. Fresher than a fresh coat of paint on a wet fence. You can barely catch a glimpse from behind a fresh tint. Fresher than a fresh print, sucking on a breath mint. Ever since I got fresh, I ain't been less since. I'm fresh.
It's your man DJ Buff Nuts, and we here live on 916.5 Yo Finger Radio. We're ready to get it in, you bitches. Yeah, can you dig it? Yo bitch waking up and ain't coming home with that motherfucking Benz, man. Yo nigga ain't coming home with that Benz. Call 1-800 Lead Jack.
Chasing chicken, making boss moves. Can't be working on my fucking day off. Cause ain't a nigga that can do my job. That can do my job.
But dancing with the devil, right hand on the Bible, left hand on the metal. Slide through the ghetto, the boy well equipped. The kid got screenplays, your boy selling scripts. Love from the bloods, the same from the crips. Got a plug in the town, East Bay for the kicks. Magazine full of clips, my team with the shits. Turn them all Hindu, the bean got an inf. Bruh, fuck your squad, your boss is a bitch. Face shot, I either kill him or turn him into a glitch. Fuck being broke, the objective is getting rich. You either ace of the line, you met a money making Mitch. Yeah, bitch.
No one can be trusted. Even if
competition not as effective, huh? I be counting my blessings in a way that niggas been stepping lately. It's mandatory that I keep me a weapon. It's all eyes on us when we step in. 4-5, nigga, no job, that's my best friend. So live, nigga, every time I be flexing. 4-5 bitches trying to slide to the West End. Yeah, we don't want the pack if it ain't right. We gon' double up and get it back, yeah, the same night. Anaconda in these streets, boy, my game tight. Me and my niggas on the same page, yeah, the same height.
Stats, stats. CLS on the DJ NEZ. Let's get it.
They told me that karma's a bitch. That's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling. They told me that karma's a bitch. That's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling.
Go around, come around. Niggas that you go up with and switch up when the going get tough and try to gun you down. Same way that the sun go down, it's gone, come back up again. Some of us won't make it to that breakfast or that lunch again. I done seen a bunch of men cake up when confronted with so much time that they won't see their son again. Them summers get hotter than a motherfucker. Choppers like a motherfucker. Popping by the hunters, niggas dropping like a motherfucker. Ducking from the undercovers, rocking like a motherfucker. Got it tan, got it white as cotton like a motherfucker. Gotta watch your man if he ain't rocking like a motherfucker. He might have a plan to sell you coughing like a motherfucker.
Karma's a bitch, that's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling. They told me that karma's a bitch, that's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling.
These niggas is fake as fuck. These niggas is counterfeit. These niggas is flawed as they come. These niggas is bullshit. Some bullshit. Every move that they make is designed to block your shine. But I'ma get mine if you spit and rhyme. Busting the nine. Me and mine been through some shit. Sometimes we had to do some shit. Please don't make us have to do your click on some gruesome shit. You knew it wasn't smart to be fucking around from the get go. Niggas got pop hard stopping. That's just how shit go. Boys murder hero. This ain't a fucking joke. We hotboxing this bitch cause we want all the smoke. Where you play around, what is where you lay around? Cause you won't stay around after facing AK round.
Karma's a bitch, that's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling. They told me that karma's a bitch, that's one of the reasons I rock my snake. I'm going all the way up like a ladder, my nigga, not stopping for shit. You say it's problems, you won't hit a bitch, nigga, top, then I go with my business. Check out the grind, I like to shine, stacking digits to the ceiling.
Yeah, yeah, Top Shelf Radio. That right there was Ishmael the Phoenix, COS, Double Dare ENT, featuring Stash Stacks. Karma is the name of that record. Yes, a lot of people on there, so you got to do some typing. You know what I'm saying? But it is available online if you're looking for it. Right before that, we played L Fingers featuring Graf, Solid the Great, and Bree the First Lady, Doing My Job. Before that, we had the 316 Fresh. You know what I'm saying? The album is available. Please go listen to that album if you have
Fresh.
It.
Fresh.
You know, and we started off with Big Sammy, Happy Place. So, nice little rotation right there. You know what I'm saying? Some dope music. You feel me? But now we're going to get into the, you know, the artist of the evening. You know what I'm saying? Go by the name of LV the Great.
So, yeah, welcome to the show, man.
Yo. So, thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What's your favorite late night jam, LV?
You know what? I wish I could do that voice. I was about to, I was like, damn, I can't do it. My favorite R&B jam?
What's your
favorite?
Nah,
I was
just fucking around.
Oh, I was about to give you one too.
Hey. Come on with it.
You know what I'm saying? I'm Donnell Jones. Y'all know Donnell
Jones?
Come
on, Jones? Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
You
know what yeah.
What's your favorite Donnell Jones track? If
man.
Y'all know about that.
Didn't
he do Where I Wanna Be or some shit like
I'm
that?
I'm going to go with.
Ain't that right?
Yes, he did
uh-huh.
do that.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Or that
no
the other one
Shorty Got Eyes On
Caught
Me.
That's Patrick.
It
that's yeah with
come
you
on,
yeah.
Come on.
Yeah,
if I can
shit.
Say right
it'd be a rap
if
huh?
I can say I'll be singing my drive through orders
man,
to these motherfuckers
that song
stop
crazy.
Playing
so
yeah
LV the Great
where you from and how long you been making music you know habitually and professionally.
Oh gosh, born raised Los Angeles. This is my second home. You know what I'm saying? I came out here in like the ninth grade. Graduated. So this I would call this my second home. But far as the music, gosh, really got into it about 12 years old. Mm-hmm. I was like nice. Heavy into it. You know what I'm saying? Like growing up fast, that was like something I jumped into. You know what I'm saying? That was my comfort zone. So I took it serious at a young age.
Say that.
Straight up.
Okay.
So,
how long have you been putting like music out?
Putting music out, shoot, probably for about 2 years now.
Okay.
I have a lot of stuff, you know, like backed up in the archive, but I was always, you know, moving certain situations, you know, and stuff disappear or whatnot, but we keep it pushing, we move forward, so.
Always sure. make more.
That's
you
right.
know what I mean?
That's right.
What does LV stand for?
You know what, LV, my first name is Verger.
Okay.
You know what, and LV was just, you know, something that stuck with me. You know what I'm saying?
What is the L?
The L stands for love.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So.
Like LL middle, Cool J.
Uh-huh, like ladies like, love Cool J. We were talking about LL.
Name, saying. Some people don't know.
Hey, hit that, hit him with the big LA.
Name, so, you know, LV.
Sound by one.
What? What'd you say? What'd you say? I can see like I need love. What? Y'all look like I can't sing.
We all.
Uh-huh. Hey, that LL.
Or is that I'm going to keep Eddie on his toes, bro.
It's another LV that sang on Gangsta's Paradise, and his name LV.
The bin spinning
yeah,
most
yeah,
of
yeah,
the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, yeah. The Gangsta's Paradise. Yo, I swear,
shit.
Boy.
Uh-huh.
I swear, boy.
Who are your influences, musically and just in general in
oh,
life?
Oh, gosh. Tupac, big influence. Biggie. I listen to a lot of East Coast, Spice One, Digital Underground. Redman, all that.
So you're more influenced by the like what we would consider old school or
yes.
older heads,
the
like,
legends.
Yes. And around that time, it was some hot freestyling. They was really off the head with it.
Yeah,
so.
Really off the head. Not saying this is a written freestyle. I never understood that. What's a written freestyle?
It's not. That's not possible.
Niggas say that.
Either,
oh, either
you're freestyling or you just spit.
Right. So okay. Hold on. What's a freestyle? Because we're going to have a debate right now.
I like this.
Freestyle is off the top of your head.
Everything you're coming with off the top, right?
In order for you to call it a freestyle.
But I mean, you write those things that come to mind down.
Nah.
But that's what
so you're talking about using like schemes, like having schemes ready, right? Or having a rhyme scheme, and you like, you've used it on a track, and you know it's like a good little thing, and you throw it in there or something. That's still not freestyle.
No, it's not.
Freestyle off the top.
So niggas be putting out songs nowadays where it be like one
freestyle.
Right. That shit ain't no freestyle.
You might have done it one take. You might have done that, but to me, a freestyle, like,
if you wrote it,
anything you write and you spit it, I don't care if it's from 2-3 years ago. That's not
really
a freestyle.
No.
If a nigga
so
asked
right now in this moment, you just started rapping everything that you wrote, right?
Yeah.
Like you just, I mean,
nah,
you wrote,
he's spitting.
You freestyle your freestyle, right?
Mm-hmm.
You just freestyled a cool 16, right?
Okay.
But then you took those 16 that you just spit right now
mm-hmm.
off the dome, right?
Mm-hmm.
You wrote it down.
How?
If he had a way to, if it got recorded right now, somebody did it, and then he wrote it down. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a freestyle.
But what do you call? But what do you call it if you go in there and you don't write nothing down and you lay it?
Yeah,
well, you
hook and
well, so you're punching
in,
but you just punching in like eight, like a four, or something like that. Like, is what you're saying? Like doing a bunch of punches, like how Jay-Z would come up with
correct.
Yeah,
that's freestyle. If you coming off the dome, you ain't no pencil or phone involved, and you just
I'm not knocking writers. I'm not saying I don't want to take nothing away from
but
my
but here's
right,
the here's
now,
the thing
just,
though. Some people disagree with what a freestyle is, right? Like some people say a freestyle is free of style, right? It's free of, and motherfuckers have argued with me about this, bro. I'm dead serious.
Free
it's free of style. Now it means it's free of style. Like you just wrote it. Like you ain't talking about nothing. You just write. I said nah. That ain't it.
Stop
like
it.
If it's got to me, I mean just because where I come from. It's got to be all off the top of the dome. Like, you be like, I can point shit out in the room and you rap about it.
So, but what I'm saying, though, is like, okay, you spit it off the head, but let's just say, I mean, I know a couple of rappers that can remember a lot of shit that they say in the span of, you know, a 16-bar verse, right? Ugh. And they go back and write what the fuck they just freestyled down. Is that still considered a freestyle? Because he didn't write it at first. He rapped it out of his head and then wrote it down.
I don't know. It's a gray area.
Wait, say that again? Run that back?
You freestyled a song, right?
But you remember it.
But you remember what you said, right? Correct. So you go and write it down, right?
Correct.
It's still a freestyle.
But I think, like me, I remember it and won't write it down.
It come from here. Whether it's
on paper.
You just
gonna go do it.
Yeah.
Why do you need to write it down after you freestyle?
It's just a question.
Everybody's right. Everybody's writing process is different, right? You know what I mean? The motherfuckers do shit different ways.
Is that your writing process, period? Do you not write at all?
As I got more mature in the music, I learned that writing is a part of music, and you can't shy away from that.
Facts, because I know a lot of people are artists that punch in, and boy, they don't be doing a good
thing. Nah, but I'll be honest, though. I wrote a lot of my songs just in my head, not on paper.
Yes.
You type
that's how I do it.
But no,
the whole thing?
Yeah, the whole thing from the beginning to end, for sure. Okay. A lot of that Humphrey shit too.
Okay.
But that's just, I always practice, like, when I fuck up, I start over, right? So if I get to like the third bar and I'm trying to come up with the fourth, I keep starting over, so I remember the beginning. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
like,
right.
Our Jay-Z did it sometime when I was a kid or something. I was like, I'm doing that. Mm-hmm. But that's just something like we'll be riding in the car and I'll just write my shit while I'm riding. Just put, like, right now I can go through my beat stars, like all my loved beats, you know what I mean? And I got like a verse and a hook for like 20 songs because I had a freestyle. Like, I did something that came up with a thing and then wrote it and then moved on to the next
one. But is that still a freestyle when you go back to rap because it came off of your head? It was a freestyle to begin with.
I mean, I wrote it in my head. It's not a freestyle. What I did this when you first walked into the OB, that's a freestyle. Off the top, nothing. Like, just talking
niggas
about
have changed the standards. All this new generation to change the shit around. They want to change the way shit. No, that's not.
If it's
for the record,
the wheel rolls for a reason. You know what I mean? Right. Like, it's a motherfucking wheel. Come on, we're trying to change this. We're trying to change it.
Right. Trying to change the rules.
Nah, let's get back because we don't want to get straight too far from what we talking about. This man, we can get in a heated debate about.
that's a good topic right there. Or you could run with that.
Yeah.
So what you got? What do you got dropping right now? What can the world expect from you? What's to look for?
Right now, Hear Me Now. That's coming soon. Well, actually, I already have that out. You can go.
And
check
that's on
that
all
out.
Digital, Apple
yes,
Music,
Spotify, all that good stuff.
That's a single.
Yes. You can go.
And
check
that's
that
what
out.
That's LV the.
LV the great D-A-G-A-T-T.
All one word.
Correct.
Yep.
There's nothing wrong. Some people like to separate it, but you might not find me that way.
People always try to tell you how to say your name. You know how many shows Doe the Uncone did? Because people don't know how to spell unknown.
How are you gonna tell me?
You know how many times I went by Go Racimo?
Yeah.
Or Ramico?
Or Racimo?
Yeah.
I swear I've gotten it hell of times. I just be like, you know, Simo.
I say names wrong. I said your name wrong forever. Until I really like met you, I did.
What was his name?
That Goracimo.
Goracimo.
Yeah, I promise. That's all.
I'm telling you, people come to me like Goracimo. I'll be like, that's not it, bro. But what's
that
up?
That shit go, Racimo.
Come on,
say it again.
My producer name is This Shit Goracimo. Right. That's what I go by. But like my name that I go by, you know, in the music world is Racimo. You know, people call me Racimo or Simo. You know.
He didn't put no spaces in it, so people like me just try to
it's
make
one
a word.
Whole
like,
shit.
It's like together. Looking at a license plate, maybe that like, personalized license
this
plate.
This Shigoro Simo?
This Shigoro Simo.
That'll be the great.
So describe your style to us, to the world, to the people who haven't heard you before.
Very different.
How so?
Just off the matter of fact, let me take that back. Every time I spit, a lot of people be like, oh, they compare me to Meek Mill. Nothing wrong. You know, I like Meek Mill. I think he's cool. You know what I'm saying? But that's what an instant comparison as far as me and
people,
my style.
People always try to do comparisons.
It's cool. You know what I'm saying? I like to be me. You know,
they could say you were somebody like horrible. You know what I mean?
So, I don't lie. I remember you came to the bars event and came to rap. You was spitting some shit on mama. You was going crazy. I remember.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be trying to run them up. I need to get back into them.
We need to run them back up, but you know the weather got us fucked up.
Right.
The weather got us fucked up.
Right.
No doubt. So, writing and recording process.
Mm-hmm.
You say you freestyle a lot, but you say you can't get away from the writing, though.
Right.
So you do write sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, because as you grow, and certain songs has to have a concept. You know what I'm saying?
So are you, or would you say you're more of a concept-driven writer?
I would say I'm in between. You know what I'm saying? I have my days if I'm into it, you know what I'm saying? Or I try to, when it comes to writing, I try to write about, you know, reality. You know what I'm saying? What I go through, not something I seen somebody else go through. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I got to be in that mood for that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a good thing.
I try. That's how you keep it real.
Right? Yeah, for real.
We appreciate that.
Yes.
Like I think I respect somebody more that when they rap, they sounds like them than like a lot of people try to be what they think a rapper is. Right. Right? Like a lot of people, I gotta rap a certain way. Right. This is what's hot. I gotta rap like this.
Voice and all kind of man. Shit.
Right. I like motherfuckers that's just them. Like, come on. You don't even care if you goofy, rap goofy. Come on. You know what I'm saying? Like,
own that goofy shit.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Yeah. I gotta be able to understand. Like, look at you and know. Okay, damn.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If you over here. Just total square bear, and you're talking all this trap drill shit.
Hibbity hoopla.
Yeah.
Right, right. I mean, I have. I think every artist should have like that telling a true story, and then you should have that cocky side.
Uh huh.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah, be cocky, but that don't be cocky to the point where you're lying.
No.
Oh,
no,
God.
No lies. No lies, man. I'm saying like cocky in your craft, right? Mm. You know what I'm saying?
But hold on, though, because niggas like Rick Ross, and Rick Ross was talking about watches he ain't even have yet. So, talking about he was having them.
I know an artist, we're going to keep him nameless, but they rap from a perspective of speaking things into existence.
That's how he pitched it to you?
Yeah.
Is that lying? Is that lying in rap?
Get him on your marketing team. That is a salesman.
If you're speaking it.
What you think, LB, is that lying in your raps?
I think so.
Yeah, I'm not lying. I'm just making a wishboard out of my rap.
What if you never get it?
But if and you like
yeah, then it's a lie, right?
What if you lay this trap
and a nigga come up to you and be like, "So where's that Bugatti that you was talking about in your song?" Well, I don't got it yet.
To the shop right now,
but
it's on the way.
But it's coming. It's in my future.
I'm getting a body kit put on that. It's in the shop right now.
You know, to each their own. You know what I'm saying? I prefer just being honest.
So would you say like go through like. How you would come up with a song? Me and Simo was talking about it too. Like how he comes up with a beat. Like what gets you going? Like, let's say, do a lot of your writing just kind of through the day? You get an idea, or is it something like, okay, I got a studio session, but I'm coming here, I'm gonna try to write four songs in the session, or do you go to the session like with four songs already ready type of shit?
I just go in with no songs ready for number one.
You write best.
So you write best in the studio?
Yes. I write best in the studio. I freestyle, you know, when I'm just in that environment, you know what I'm saying? But I go in there and it's the beat, you know what I'm saying? I got to feel something. If it don't make my head nod in some sort of way or I'm not just feeling it or vibing with it, then nothing. Yeah. Let's move on to the next.
If you had to put a time on yourself, like to, you know, start and finish a song, right, in the session, how long would you think it'd take you? In a 2-hour span.
Oh gosh. A 2-hour span.
Give it to me quick.
25 minutes.
Okay.
Probably less.
Okay, that's
already ready.
Whole song.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. So it's like,
that's impressive.
I get to work. I'd have had a lot of, you know, situations where I went to a studio. And I barely pay for studio time. Not saying I'm somebody spectacular, but it's just like,
it's a luxury.
I be vibing, you know what I'm saying? And the flow is there, you know what I'm saying? So I went in there. The one time I did pay for a session, and he gave me my money back.
Ooh, what?
In a good way, though. Okay. Cause you gotta, yeah, you can't pause like, too long after that.
You did this too fast. He was like,
I barely had to do anything.
I don't want to take your money,
like,
bro.
I really ain't got nothing. But, he was like, I'm gonna, you know, put my touches on it, but.
And that's going in. You don't got none of the structures ready. None of the shit. You just come in. You can play me a beat, and then however they got it broke down, you wrote it down.
Like I'll listen to the beat, and then I'll come up with a hook. That's the first thing I'm gonna come up with before I even touch walk inside the booth. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I gotta have a hook. You know what I'm saying? So
gonna set the foundation. For
the beat gotta be there. Once I lay the hook, I'm in there right after. We gunning it down.
So we were talking earlier. We doing 2 verses and a hook. We doing 3 verses, or it just depends on the song, right?
It depends on the song. Yeah.
No standard format. Just
you heard it.
When I get done talking,
when it's done. Yeah. Yo, sometimes I be having moments where it's no need for a hook. I just want to go in there and flame some shit.
Come on.
That's how I feel a lot of the time. That's why it be hard for me sometimes to sit there and want to write some, you know, sit there and come on a song. Because half the time I hear a beat, if it's fire, just let me go in there and burn that bitch.
A hook is not necessary in every situation.
Hey, we can do that in a little bit after we play your songs. We got a booth. You can come on and flame right now.
Yeah. I spit hot shit.
Put a beat on. Put a beat on fire. Go ahead. I got lighter.
Hey, since I've been on the show, we have not had nobody rap yet. Yeah. But it's a little six rap for a little bit.
Okay.
You know, but I mean... you can bust it at that mic. Okay, right,
bust it at that mic.
Well, let's get into let's play some of this music first, and then come back to that.
Yeah, you could play with some beats, throw some beats on. Yeah, with them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what are we gonna play right now, Hen?
Let's kick it off with what you got a preference? Yeah. LV.
Hear me now.
Yes, by LV.
And this
Great.
Is this available right now?
This is available right now.
LV
the Great.
Shout out to Slap Jaw.
Pick that shit up.
Go check it out.
Shout out to Slap Jaw too, because that's the homie.
All the viewers, go make sure you go over to that. Tap in, put a like, let them know we here, man. Send them top shelf love. Let's go.
You ain't messing P, you ain't body body. Boy, I'm master with these P's, bitch, I'm body body. You ain't master with these P's, you ain't body body. You know that. Look, bitch, I'm master with these P's. I know they mad, I've been running through these checks again. Diamond splashing, should've put me on ESPN. Lame niggas get no love, they getting checked again. And bitches love you when you ballin', that's just the way it is. I know they mad, I've been running through these checks again. Diamond splashing, should've put me on ESPN. And lame niggas get no love, they getting checked again. And bitches love you when you ballin', that's just the way it is. Keep it lit, you get smoked like a cigarette. I'm PS5, you just an Xbox, you serious? Curious drawers getting curious, I'm killing it. Me, myself, and I on some moonwalk thriller shit. Vanilla whip just to match my bitch. And I'm expensive, bitches love me just like chocolate chips. Left behind, enemy line, shit, not one of mine. I heard you say yo bitch a dime when that hoe a nine. Flexible with all these verses, I've been like a spine. You know well we've been the greatest, I'm one of a kind. And I am legend till these mummies get buried alive. And you ain't gotta have a mask to know you getting robbed. And the rollie all yellow, that's caught on a cop. You say you love you, but that bitch get more turns than a knob. And I'm daddy to these rappers, I'm teaching them all. Money so tall, if you jump, you gon' slip and fall. I know a few niggas claiming that they fucking ballin'. When I see them in person, they just fucking fallin'. Like a car bad battery that's fucking stallin'. Treat these hoes like Pokemon, collect them all then. Bet I get a pussy wet like Niagara Falls then. Thought I was Jim Jones the way a nigga ballin'. Independent with no label, but got labels callin'. Marathon with this money, they like LV all then. And I got a God glow, that mean that God was callin'. Hello? Hello? Could you hear me now? Hello? Hello? Fuck nigga, all them niggas hatin'. Could you hear me now? Yeah. You ain't messin' with these P's, you ain't body body. Born a master with these P's, you know I'm body body. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't master with these P's, you ain't body body. Boy, I'm the master with these P's, you know I'm body body. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. I know they mad, I've been running through these checks again. Diamond splashing, should've put me on ESPN. Lame niggas get no love, they getting checked again. And bitches love you when you ballin', that's just the way it is. You ain't messin' with these P's, you ain't body body. Born a master with these P's, you know I'm body body. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't master with these P's, you ain't body body. Boy, I'm the master with these P's, you know I'm body body. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started. You ain't rowdy with these riches, so don't get me started.
Yeah. You ain't body body.
What? You know we body body. Hey, that's crazy. That's the first joint we played, and on a random, me and my girl was just bumping some Master P.
Right.
I'm body body, Ice Cream Man, all that shit. I came walking up singing the Yuck Ice Cream song because we got so deep into it. Man, that's a slap, bro.
Right. Thank you, brother.
I like the bars too. You had some dope ass punchlines on that.
Thank you.
Okay.
We went in there and did that off the head.
Yeah, that was that word.
That was off the noggin with it.
Ain't nothing wrong with that, man.
That's shout true. Out to Slap Jaw. That's my dog.
Slap Jaw. Okay, shout we out. Saw him. I saw him on the.
He on there. He's still on there. Yeah. Yeah. All the way in. That's all the way. That's dope. Hey, the producer.
That's dope,
in,
bro.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we doing a lot of work. We doing a lot of work. We still grinding.
Is that your your home producer? Do you
yeah.
strictly fuck with him?
Yeah. Okay. I don't really. You know, we tapped in.
He produced that beat too?
Yes. Mm. Yes. He does like all my beats.
There nice. Go.
Yeah, that motherfucker yank.
Yeah, that go crazy. That go crazy. That was a good vibe when we went in there and did that. That was like a 15-minute drill. We was okay. in and out.
What motivates you to create music?
It's in the heart, you know. It's like a lot of people do music, you know, of course for the check, you know. We can't deny that. We all want that, no cap. But for me, it's just like I said, it was always an outlet. You know what I'm saying? So it was like I didn't watch TV and be like, damn, I want to rap. You know what I'm saying? Like,
so were you around it? Like, what? Like, how'd you get introduced to music?
I was always around it.
Who was around you making music that you like when you learn how to record, doing like, you really take it serious?
It was just being played around me. It was like a talent for me. You know what I'm saying? It was like my pops, big music head. You know what I'm saying? A lot of East Coast music. He was always, you know, playing it around me. You know, every day, in and out. You know what I'm saying? And it was like it stuck with me. And then as you grow, when you go through things. There it is. That's your life story right there. You know what I'm saying? So it was always in me. That's my passion. You know what I'm saying? I do it for me, myself. You know, just my personal situation. That's my outlet.
Probably best case scenario, you in 10 years. Where you at?
10 years? Where I'm at? I'm at the top of the charts. 10 years.
Say that.
Period. We speaking it into existence.
So I mean,
and that's a good.
That's
not like look. Let me tell you that. So it's not like dropping a track.
That's called a callback.
Right. And 2 months later, you still ain't got that Bentley.
Yeah. Yeah. No. That's no. People but, have spoken things into the universe on my sure. show, and it's.
Well, I got a question. Okay. Have you ever set a goal for yourself and accomplished it?
Yeah.
So it's possible, right?
Right.
Right.
What's like your long term? Like 10 years, do you give yourself like?
I got a 5 year, but I got a major 10. You know what I'm saying? But yeah,
I got a 5 for sure.
Definitely, all of the above. Year, right. 5 year, 10 year. You know what I'm saying?
Here the whole.
I got next year. Goddamn it!
We here the whole time.
It can happen any second though. It can happen any moment. God. All it take is a year.
But I mean, okay, so 10 years, you see yourself just making music, or you see yourself expanding into other aspects, like, you know, doing, people do other stuff, you know, there's NFTs, there's Bitcoin, there's, you know what I'm saying, like all kinds of different shit. What kind of shit are you looking into?
Definitely the cannabis area.
Let's talk about that, because I love weed.
Yes. I have a lot of good things. I actually have my own pre-roll company, Rolling Rich Pre-Rolls. We do exotic pre-rolls. I'm talking about fat like Cuban cigars.
That's 24
karat gold.
Just pre-rolls?
Yeah, we do custom pre-rolls. Like we do weddings and bachelor parties. We do a lot of stuff like that. So
I've always thought with pre-rolls, because if it's not nicely packaged and you know, put together and looking all shiny, you know what I'm saying? Like some people don't want you to roll their weed for them.
Right, correct.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, but there's a big market for it though, with the infused shit, like, you know what I mean? But like you said, like the moon rocks, but then they have joints that are dipped and got wax inside of them and got
like mine.
And it's different. Not that's on the nook. That's moon rocks.
Okay.
But like with stuff that they're doing now, like you can get a like a $50 cigar that's like over an eighth of top shelf flour, not shake, you know what I'm saying? Right. And then got fucking like resin all through it. It got keef in it, you know what I mean? Like you smoke that motherfucker like for 2 days, if you know what I'm saying?
Right. Correct. I have one that'll last you about almost a week.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah. Like,
so what made what got you into that? Just being a hustler or
a hustler? And I went to one of the little venues, right? And I was like, I'm the type of individual, if I see something, I'm going to do it. You know what I'm saying? If I put my mind to it, I'm going to figure it out. Even if you don't want to tell me.
Why pre-rolls?
Because when I used to go to the dispensaries, of course, y'all probably experienced this. You get the pre-roll, and it be grinded up so fine that when you hit that
shake,
motherfucker.
Or a shake. It's like bottom of the bag.
Right.
Bullshit.
It's going in your mouth. And then it be some garbage-ass treat to me.
Yeah.
That's just me. I got a pre-roll backwood. I got something like that for you. And a lot of people don't do pre-roll backwoods. That's a different situation.
And you're in stores with those or what?
We are working on it right now. I'm at a lot of venues. I was supposed to be at the Gold Cup. It was in San Francisco. I was supposed to run that up, but
You ever run into people that be like, hey, what's in this? Like,
I get a lot of people that's like, what's in that?
But not like in a, like, ooh, like, what's in this? I'm talking about, like, you trying to, like, drug me within
this. Yes. So, when I do get those customers who ask that question, I have to give them, like, a full detail. And I might have an example of right in front of you of what's inside of this. Because you might have some people, like, I had a customer, she was like, oh, I'm allergic to, you know, I forgot what she said. She was like, I'm allergic to backwoods, or, you know, something's in nicotine or whatever might mess me up. So I was like, okay, we got joints.
Yeah.
I got some of my pre-rolls been dipped in 100% THC liquid oil and cured in that for like 2 weeks. So every joint, every one of my pre-rolls, all it takes is one.
And when people can find these, like, the, this is...
Yes, right now with the pre-rolls, because we just dropped, I just got my logo and all that together. It took a while to get that LLC when you come in correct.
Yeah. A lot of hoops to jump through.
Yes, a lot. A lot of money to spend, a lot of hoops to jump through. So that's where we at right now. I'm actually working on a website and things like that, but also do a little something else. I do exotic clones. Y'all into the clone? Y'all like clones?
Yeah.
I just ain't got nowhere to put it, but I would.
Right. So we do stuff like that. We have like exotic seeds, grow exotic clones, stuff from like Dubai, way over there, stuff that's hard to get your hands on.
Okay. My question is, did you bring some exotic pre-roll?
You know what? Johnny, what I say?
Come on.
I said, man, I fucking forgot.
Damn it.
But check it out. I'll do a drop off on you. Because I want you to try my product.
I'm like that. We're here every Sunday at 9 p.m.
Well, I'll be here.
Every Sunday.
I'll be here. I'm going to drop. Look. I'm a whip all three of a nice bag.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah, please.
A nice bag.
Please. I need to smoke a week and it's hard to even envision something like that, because I mean I just like smoking it, and it's hard to put it out once you light it up. But if it's something that make me say I'm done, put it out.
I got something that's gonna tap you out.
I need that.
I had a customer. She had bought one of my pre-rolls, left. She came back to another little venue I was at. And she was like, that shit was so strong, I fell asleep in the middle of the movie and it burnt a hole in my couch. Oh. She said, let me get 15 of those.
She wasn't mad, huh? She was happy.
I like being that high.
Night, motherfucker.
Like, okay, then I'm doing my job.
Right. Motherfucking time.
All it takes is one.
That's crazy. Yeah, we need it in our life. Yeah.
Let's get into this.
Back by? Come on down.
Let's get into this next song.
What else we got?
Rocco's Mindset?
Yes.
I'm a fucking tired.
What?
I'm a fucking tired.
So, Eddie, let's get into the next joint, Rocco's Mindset. This is Rocco's Mindset by LV the Great. Check him out. This one's available too?
Yes, sir.
All right. Everywhere digital. Come fuck with it.
I've been riding with some niggas, some gorillas from the zoo. Pop up smoke, come eat this toast, now baby, welcome to the woo. Ain't no lies, only truth, now come and sip this jungle juice. She got the drop on her op, now baby, sip this on that food. Got his name, I ain't run no game, heard this boy a lame. It's a shame, we gon' do him dirty, wash him like a stain. Now shorty gang, yeah, she on my dick and I ain't running game. I'ma kick it like it's Nike, cause she down to let it bang. And her best friend fuck this nigga and she down to make some change. Hope that nigga got a towel, cause I'm wetting everything. So that bitch make the call, she gon' set a fade thing. Gave her the bag, smacked her on the ass, sent her on her way. What's the addy? Don't repeat it twice, cause that's a sketchy play. Niggas walking by the window, about to make them pay. What's the addy? Don't repeat it twice, cause that's a sketchy play. See two niggas walking by the window, about to make them pay.
Yes, nigga. Radio, LV the Great.
Yo.
Rocco's Mindset, is that the name of it? Like Rocco's.
Hey, you ever seen
like the Rocco's Modern Life?
Like,
similar.
Okay.
Like the cartoon?
Talk to me. What is
similar?
Break it down for me.
Hard-headed. I got the Rocco socks.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hard-headed storyline.
I like cool socks. I got Tapatio socks.
That's tight.
They're bar. I love
that shit. Spicy feet.
That right there. Shout out to Slap Job. That was a little
Slap
short.
Slap Job, man.
A little
hey,
short something.
Tap in, bro. Send some music in, bro. We interview producers too, bro. That shit slap.
Yes. He needs to get in here and get something in rotation.
For real.
Come that right there, us. We whipped that up pretty fast. That was like just a small experience. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like I said, I keep it short. I try to rap about stuff I've been through.
Right. As you should.
Right. So that was just like a small situation, something I've been through in life. You know what I'm saying? I'm just putting it on wax. I'm saying a little jealous, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
A little jealous chick, little play. I ain't gonna go into it too much.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But that's when I was in my you know.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. You got to, you know, experiences make good stories, you know what I'm saying?
Sir.
So you
got
to
go through
some shit to talk about.
So, Eddie. Eddie, you got some CMO beats or what?
Is that this one playing? Of them right here.
Hey, okay. LV, you feel like blessing us?
Oh, you know.
Come on.
It's hotter than the hell.
Come on, that's CMO right there on the beat.
Yeah, he can only hear the headphones, right? That's fine.
That's fine. Come on with it.
Okay. But LV been the greatest. Look, I overshine. They think I'm Tony Hawk, the way this nigga overgrind. I bust that on my, yo bitch been on my dick again, fiddling. I gotta do and twitch it off that Ritalin. I double down, bust that on my wrist, I make her panties wet. Niggas talking shit, I better slip, I got the antidote, we antied up. Niggas talking shit, but they ain't did enough. I bet you sit up in that room with the DA, they gon' call your bluff, you giving it up. 4-5 on me, clutch, when I'm in a clutch, gotta get it up. Ain't nobody really on my level, nigga, hard like heavy metal, nigga. I'm one of the greatest, I know that you hate it. They say that I'm cocky, she sickin' the dick and she sick it like sake. Your bitch on my dick and she suckin' it sloppy. Drippin' on niggas like water. Running the game, tell me to play. Ballin' them up, NBA. Chop on me and that 4 on display. Rendered it up cause I'm getting that K. Whippin' that shit like my name ain't a man. Niggas on me cause the diamond display. Bling, blah, running the mouth. Niggas be talking, we gon' run you down. Niggas be claiming they hot till we sort like an eagle. I guarantee it, I hope you down. A little bit right there. You got a couple of them?
Little something light.
I got hella that shit.
Hey, that man went in.
Okay.
LV the Great, ladies and gentlemen.
I got hella that shit.
That.
I ain't gonna lie, I've been fucking with you since you was rapping at the bars thing.
I appreciate it, bro.
I swear, I was like, damn, ever since I seen you, I was like, damn, how the fuck can I catch up to bro? Like, goddamn.
I'm not even capping.
We locked in, bro. Now. I was saying the same thing. I'm just like, me? I'm like, if I don't really know you, I'll be like, play the, you know.
Yeah.
I'll be like, I'll catch bro next time and next time. And then probably after the fifth time, I'm like, yo, what's up?
Let's dive in. You gotta fuck with it.
Period.
That was tight.
Yeah, that was raw. Mm-hmm.
We here now. You know what I'm saying? Things happen for a reason. That's why you're here. Mm-hmm. Happen to be my co-host.
That's
you know
right. So. You know, and you not always should need a beat to spit some raw.
Oh, come on.
Say that.
Come on. Right. I love acapellas. Go for it.
You like acapellas?
Yeah, acapellas is shit, bro. That's my thing. Come on. Go ahead. Get down with it.
Look, Marley, look it away. Like, go ahead, boy.
Come on.
I spit that hot shit. You ain't the hottest. A lot of niggas get on 360, can't spit the topic.
Come on.
We running up them bands again. Niggas fall asleep on your flow. They need an ambience. I fuck around and fuck your beat up. You need an ambience. An ambulance. Running up a mile, it's nothing. They get a thon. I had to do the shit for Nipsey. I swear that's a marathon. Look, tag team with the chopper. Wouldn't miss when I pop you. Shorty on that dick. I hit the coochie. She hit high notes like the opera. Niggas saying that they ready, but your flow an imposter. I'm a mob boss nigga at the table eating lobster. Let's get back in the section. I'm fucking up like Kobe. Everybody in I said hey. I fuck it up. I ball like Kobe. You can't digest it. I'm in your veins like COVID, nigga. You know this nigga. Long shot with the four. I'm finna blow this nigga. Go get your bitch. She on my tip. She finna blow this nigga. I wouldn't miss. I got shot. Call me Kobe, nigga. I overdosed on the flow, my nigga. A lot of niggas get in the booth and they knows that's Pinocchio, my nigga. They just lie on the flow, my nigga. When it come to the crack, my flow that. You wanna sniff that dope, my nigga? A real block boy, you know my nigga. I'm from the Ave where niggas don't snitch, but a lot of niggas sell soap there, that hope there. I was a wild boy in that gear. My daddy was a hustler, used to whip up that coke gear.
Yeah. All right.
Bar, let that man go.
Come on.
Ah.
Yeah. We got to get
Top
back
shelf
to that.
Radio.
We got to get back to that. You know
right?
What
yeah, man. Yeah. I think about that the other day. But we hadn't asked nobody.
Yeah, yeah. I meant to make it a standard, man. You got to rap with
LV, the motherfucking great. They call him the great for a reason, y'all.
Five Fingers of Death beats.
Let's
do it.
We don't necessarily.
It's going to be mixed up beats in one.
Come on, let's do it. Watch, we got a lot of shit coming for you.
All right.
Just give him a beat.
Yeah.
Give me a beat.
We need a little sample. Of somebody going, give me a beat,
right?
Just play it before anybody freestyles. As soon as that you hear that, then you know you got to freestyle.
Use that when Cassidy battled Freeway, and he was like, put on the beat,
yeah,
put on the beat.
Let's get that.
Put on the beat.
Let's get that.
Put on the beat.
And that'll be when we have rappers in on the show. That's the challenge. If you hear that, you have to rap after it. Put on the beat.
Right.
Y'all just have like
just randomly hitting when like in the middle of talking about something too. Just put on the beat. You got to rap.
Got
that's
you.
Dope.
That might be tight.
Yeah.
We got
that. Bring me on here to try that out when y'all get that in effect.
Okay.
Let's get it.
No doubt. Let people know what you have available online for purchase or download.
Right now, you can download Hear Me Now, Rocco's Modern Life. I got that out. That's the actual the whole name. That's why I was like, damn, he already knew.
Rocco's Modern Life.
Yeah. You know, so you can download that, Spotify, all that good stuff, Apple Music. Go catch it. I'm constantly dropping shit. Check my IG out, all that good stuff.
IG is LV the Great?
Yes, LVDAGREAT. Okay. One word.
Follow that, man. And the same thing on it's one word on all the platforms.
Everything. Okay. Apple Music, all that. LV the Great, one word.
Okay. Do you have a project out? I feel like I came across the project that you
know dropped. What? I have the one on Apple Music right now. Okay. It's just like 3 tracks. That was something I just, you know, sometimes you just gotta.
Did you call it an album?
Take that back.
That's called a callback, ladies and gentlemen.
That's like a little EP, a little something.
Fuck that! I'm calling my shit an album. My shit got 4 songs on this album.
Well, just because it's an EP don't mean it ain't an album. Nigga, if you feel like that shit is an album, then it's an album.
It's an album.
That's what we gonna do.
So you would call
all that shit album.
I like that.
I'm not saying the EP ain't an album.
I guess I try to stage myself because I be like, when I get to the album, I want it to be like fire. I want to be proud to say. This is the main
event. Yeah, this what you've been leading up to. Right.
So, the way they say about releasing shit too. They talk about releasing singles more than albums. Mm-hmm. Anyway, especially when you think about with Spotify with the release radar, you can only put one song up. You know what I'm saying? Like I made that mistake with my album is that I should have released more singles first on Spotify so that those got on their own algorithmic playlist instead of me just dropping the whole album. Now some of them songs have a chance to kind of get lost because.
But you could go back.
Yeah. No, you can't just go back unless you need to show me that because I don't know.
I got you.
Hey, but LV. So yes. we got a little game. We've been playing with the guests. Okay. It's kind of like a little 3 question thing. We'll hit you with some 3 questions. We're gonna scratch the first one, Henny, because Simo got a question.
Yeah, that's some real shit. It's some real shit, right?
I like Uno.
Fuck one, kill one, marry one, right?
Ooh.
Queen Latifah, ooh. Whoopi Goldberg, and Michelle Obama.
Fuck one, kill one, marry one. Queen Latifah, Whoopi Goldberg, Michelle Obama. Go.
Damn. Hey, I ain't gonna lie, I'm about to Vans and Michelle Obama, you know what I'm saying? I'm killing Whitney. Who you said?
Whoopi.
Queen Latifah.
Whoopi gotta go.
Whitney already dead.
Queen Latifah.
Whitney dead. Yeah. That's right. Whitney's already dead.
He said Whitney dead.
Queen Latifah, Whoopi Goldberg, Michelle Obama.
Fuck one, kill one, marry one.
Queen Latifah, bro.
You gonna crack those?
You
make
me drop my water, saying,
"Unity."
I'm
You said you gonna kill Whoopi.
And you married?
Whoopi's out of there. She farted. I don't know if y'all seen that on that show one time. Good Morning America.
She farted.
Oh, she's ripping cheeks. What? She's ripping cheeks live on air.
Look. Hey, she tore it up.
We need to get that sample,
he said
Eddie.
He taking Michelle Obama to the crib.
Michelle going.
So you met you fucking Michelle or you marrying her?
Papers.
I'm about. Damn, I don't want to fuck Queen Latifah. Damn, I'm marrying Michelle.
Just one night. Just a one time thing. She'll probably want a scissor or something. You know what I mean? Like,
shit.
Just a one time thing.
I can't. Queen Latifah's like a. You know what I'm saying? Set it off. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, what if she comes at you like, set it off, though? Give me that.
Oh, bitch.
Asserting that dominance.
not happening.
Hey, that's in no means are we trying to make too much fun. That's a legend. That's Queen Latifah. She'll probably beat my ass in real life, too. Anyways, but. So, okay, let's go. Let's go to the next one, Hen.
Okay. A lot of artists would like to hope that, you know, music is paying their bills and everything like that, but a lot of us have a 9-to-5.
It's not paying mine.
What is your 9-to-5?
What is my 9-to-5?
Yeah, what do you do?
My business. As far as the Rolling Rich pre-rolls, that's like booming for me right now.
You don't. That's paying your bills?
That's entrepreneur.
Right now. Okay. That's paying my bills. Salute. You know what I'm saying? I didn't think so. I'm not going to lie. Before that, I did have a 9-to-5.
Right. So what's the job LV the Great did before he was a rapper?
What did you quit to go be entrepreneur?
I was in the school industry.
Okay. Doing what?
I was a specialist, so basically I taught curriculum to the teachers to teach to the students with special needs and things like that.
Okay,
nice.
So That was my thing for what, like 4 years.
You go to school for that, or?
Yeah, I had to go to school for that.
And, any of that schooling that you learn through that, are you using it in your career?
My schooling?
Mm-hmm.
I guess you could say that. In a way, probably not. I mean, that was specified for, you know, me being a specialist to help, you know, kids learn better. You know what I'm saying? Because not every kid learns the same.
Would you ever go back to your high school and go talk to the kids about being an entrepreneur?
Definitely. I'm actually setting some up where I'm going to go back to my high school, and I want to do, like, seminars for, like, bullying. Nice. I have a few black belts myself.
Black belts are what?
Oh gosh, Taekwondo, Kenpo, Jiu-Jitsu.
Okay, I'm Kenpo. I'm a Kenpo guy.
Yeah,
I fuck with Kenpo. Yeah.
Who'd you?
I didn't never finish, and then I always dropped out.
Okay, shout out to Daryl Leiter. That was my
anytime
that was
I
my
ever
teacher.
Took anything, it was Kenpo. It was I can't even remember the name of it. It was out in Fairfield, Vacaville.
Okay, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Then I did Shaolin.
Okay, nice.
I did a few just so I could be well rounded. You know what I'm saying? You never know if somebody knows what you know or
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So, I mean, so you think you took any of that discipline?
I took that with me, like,
in
to
life,
this day.
Right, yeah.
I apply it to everything. Yeah. And I feel like that's why I'm able to accomplish a lot of things. You know what I mean?
That's nice.
Self-motivation, discipline.
No doubt. That's dope.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I you want to hit him with the last question?
You got the paper, though. I don't know what it is.
Oh, okay. Crazy experience. Oh, either yeah. on the road. Or
what's a crazy story in the studio, on the road, on the show?
Bad, crazy, could be good, crazy. Just something that stand out in your head.
Oh, shoot. Since we talking about it. Martial arts. That was like, I had to compete. I was at the Worlds, and you got to, like, at that time, fight, like, a lineup of people. Like, and if you don't lose, you keep fighting. So the lineup usually can go anywhere from, like, 15 to 30 people.
Lord.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, I was surprised I won because it was like, that's a lot of work.
You beat up 30 niggas?
Yeah.
But, but this is competition, so it's like,
humans with different styles.
But do you get, like, a break after you drop one after one? It's like, you know, you drop one, take a little, you know?
Like, do you have to beat them by a knockout or it's by points?
Either or. If I knock you out, it's game over. Next. Yeah. And at that time, that's your time to recuperate. That's why it's the Worlds. You know what I'm saying? It's like, tough shit.
Yeah.
Then you're like fighting competitors who know different art shit that you don't know, and that's why you gotta be well.
This is like you going against people that know different shit. This is like this one specific martial art.
This is like right the
Kwando
world
and
the
Jiu-Jitsu. World,
right, I might know Taekwondo.
This is a whole wide world, Craig. This is the whole world, Craig.
Tai Chi. You might do grappling. LV, you know what I'm saying?
Not only does LV have hands, like, he has feet too. Yeah, what he's trying to let us know.
I love my legs.
He might kick you in your face.
Is it difficult to go up against a wrestler?
They probably don't wrestle, though. It's probably not grappling, is it?
Well, it's takedowns. Mm-hmm. Everything goes.
They be slamming a fuck.
So it's like
judo, hip toss.
I took it. You know what I'm saying? That was one of my arts I took. You know what I'm saying? Wrestling. So it's like, and that's why I have 6 black belts, because you got to learn to be well-rounded.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what if we go to the ground? My mom is a grandmaster, Shaolin. This is like breaded in my family, like passed down generations. My kid, my boys do it. It's like, you had no choice. You could do basketball. I don't care if you want to play soccer. But you gonna do this too. And you gonna get good grades. But you gonna do this too.
Yeah.
Period.
I like that.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. That's dope.
My daughter's a boxer.
Ooh, that's dope.
Yeah, she's a 2-time champ.
Really?
Yeah, man. She be beating everybody up.
How old is your daughter?
She's 13.
Keep her in it.
She got hands.
And she boxes like in competitions and
yeah,
matches?
Wow. Hell yeah.
Gold gloves? Yeah.
No, not gold gloves.
What's gold gloves? How you get the gold glove?
I think that's specifically like through a certain camp that you gotta go through to get that. For sure, for sure.
How long she been doing it for?
What, like 5 years now, 6 years now, some shit like that?
Yeah, if
she's like 6.
Do you have to, like, make her do it or something like she like doing it? If she like doing it, she going to the top.
She has it. She has it down already. Now it's to the point to where, you know, it's like, you know, we're dealing with a, you know, oh, I don't want to go to practice. And, you know, I know what I got to do. I could just do it at home. And
practice? We talking about practice?
It's usually an everyday thing. It's after right after school. You know what I'm saying? Straight to practice. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is.
It's about
conditioning.
With it. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You condition for months before you go to do a fight. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Or you know you have to go practice. You know what I'm saying? This is crazy as fuck, bro. I swear. But like, you know, she got hands though.
It's a grind.
She be going crazy.
We got 3 minutes. No doubt. We got one more song from LV we want to play that he sent in. Eddie, you got that? No. He sent it a while back. He sent it from his email.
I think you said he didn't.
I didn't send it because it still didn't transfer. I just kept the two.
Oh, okay.
Put another beat on and let him close out the show.
Come on, come on. I'll close it out like that.
Let him do that.
And then we do the close out, the outro.
Yeah. It's you too?
Yep.
Look. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. I'ma kill every beat, guaranteed to run it up. No, you niggas in the rut, guaranteed to get you stuck. You was running up that bag till my niggas got you touched. I ain't the type of shit to do it, I just get a nigga rushed. See bag after bag, I could drop it on you tough. I probably spin your block, guaranteed to double up. My attitude is middle finger, I don't give a fuck. He say he hardcore, but I'm coming after rough. I'm all up in your bitch, I heard you fuck her extra rough. Them niggas said they hard, but I know that he a bluff. The chopper hit your stomach like 100 uppercuts. It's game time, nigga finna flash it off. Popping pussy like some Tylenol. Give me the rock, cause I was born to ball. Applying pressure to these niggas, they scared of heights. Pussy, he was scared to fall. I had to double down just to get my motivation right. I didn't start for 100 nights, but now I'm looking bright. Niggas hating on the kid, but I know I ain't a type. But I can fuck her in a minute, cause she know she want this bite. Game time, nigga, I'm finna ball now. I heard your dog say he was hot, he finna stall now. I know this chopper on your head, he finna call out. Like a bad day at work, he finna call out. I got your bitch checking in, nigga, like a hotel. Oh well, chopper on me, see you straight to hell. Diamonds on me, get to dancing, fuck a nigga, yeah. He the type to go to jail just to drop it well. I was jumping out that Lolo. Niggas getting mad when you do it on your solo. Knock a nigga out, I take his chain, call him Debo. This 40 on me, feeling like the Matrix, the way it reload. Pop up GTA with this chopper, we got Chico's. Run it down, sunny side, I had to bust it down. If that's your bitch, please do not bring that hoe around. Cause I'ma have her in the back, you know what's going down.
Come on.
Pass it to my nigga, finna X something. I don't wanna play, go grab the mat, we finna stretch something. Get that nigga room, sign it go boom, it's like bada bing, slot machines. All we know is we get the money, I had to stop some things.
Come on.
Just to keep it real, told him keep it ill. Electric flying with the flow, she wanna keep it ill. Heard you wasn't piping her down, she wanna meet the still. So I put it in that bitch, now we gon' keep it ill. Look, nigga, you ain't ready. I'm going hard, got your bitch busting on the belly, look. Mac 11 on me, get the drilling, sorta sweaty, look. Niggas couldn't fuck with me, niggas know what's up with me. If you diss me when I see you, nigga, then it's up, nigga. Caught him at the light, that gun blasted, now you stuck, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
He like a boat in the water.
LV, motherfucking Greg, this bitch.
Yeah.
Hey, look, I made that beat off this phone right here.
I thought you was in here making a beat while the nigga was rapping.
Right, look, I was looking like he
come up.
Him going, hey, him thought something magical was happening.
This nigga is
real life magic, y'all.
We need to do that.
Fire. Nah, that shit was lit. Shit was lit.
Thank you. Yeah. Appreciate it. Appreciate
good
it.
Good shit, man.
I need to do one with all y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man.
Let's get it.
We in the place to be. You know what I'm saying? We got the land right
now. 360 hits it from everywhere.
We can have that conversation until we get done.
Hey, you ain't know.
It's nothing. But let people know where to find you online, all your social media and all that.
Oh, God, all my social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, LV the Great, one word. Please don't separate it. You're
LVDA.
LVDAGREAT.
The Great. Yeah.
You bitch.
Period.
You busy.
And I'm always dropping content on my IG.
Okay. And then the music is online, too?
Yes. Music is online, all streaming platforms.
Everywhere digital.
Everywhere.
Spotify. Go run that up, man. Go tap into him. Go check out his videos. Go check out his music, man.
Can we expect a project from you in the coming year?
You can expect a project from me. I'm working on something right now, me and Slap Jaw. July.
That man Slap Jaw's
a monster. I'm going to have something cooking up in July.
Okay.
You know, I like to take my time with it.
Come on. As you should. Yes, tap sir. Back in with us when you get ready to release, and you release it exclusively through the 360 Radio.
You already know.
Yeah.
No doubt. Well, we appreciate having you come on, man.
Thank you.
Wish you nothing but success and prosperity as you travel. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, shout out to the team. You didn't even introduce the team.
Oh,
that's
gosh.
What we got to do, man.
Gang.
Y'all gotta come up over here so they can see
you. I got a damn cramp in my leg. Right now.
Introduce the team.
Yes,
sir.
Y'all shout out y'all social medias and things like that, too, where they can find y'all.
Tight squeeze.
Somebody dropped the wallet.
Slipping.
That's
me slipping.
Damn, hand you.
Slipping. Big slipping.
Let me get up.
All right, so introduce yourselves, man.
Shoot, you can find me on Instagram.
What's your name?
You got to talk in the mic.
The mic player.
Oh, my bad.
It's the first time, y'all.
It's all good.
It's all good.
You can find me on Instagram, Jumpshot Nellybo. You know, my name is Jonnell. I'm his little brother, you know. All okay. love and support.
Make music too?
Nah.
Okay.
Just that like a businessman, like he was pushing a commercial.
Okay. Yeah, that's all right.
Yeah.
Who that?
What's good, world? Yeah, I'm here to support my boy LV. It's MP. You can find me on Instagram, RealMP916. We're just out here doing music, man.
You do too?
Nah, I'm I do management, but
okay,
yeah,
okay.
So I fuck with the kid. He real hot. You wanna hear some hot shit? Definitely tap in with the
you
kid.
You his yeah, manager? Yeah.
Nah.
Okay.
Nothing like that. But yeah, definitely.
He's just part of the team. Okay. Boys,
you know what I'm saying? Sharing, liking, posting.
No doubt.
That's how you gotta do it. You know what I'm saying? Promotion is free. Y'all promote your boys.
Yeah. It takes 2 seconds to push that share button, man. Motherfuckers act like it's so hard. Then who else we got? We got one more.
Shit, I'm a rapper producer.
Yeah.
What's your name, bro?
Mahl.
Okay.
MAHL, 3 underscores.
No, that's IG?
Yeah, IG.
Okay.
And then that's about it.
You got music online?
Yeah, I mean,
Where can I find it?
Some shit. We cooking it up. We gonna be on Spotify, Apple Music, all that.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Shouts out to
No doubt, no doubt. Here to support
Mahl,
that guy,
3 underscores.
Man.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what's up, man.
We gotta let the young boys get some love. You know what I mean?
Right. No doubt. Yeah. LV the Great, man. Follow him online. You know what I'm saying? IG, if you like the music, go support what he's doing. Run the streams. You got visuals out too?
Not yet. We're working on it.
Okay.
We're working on it.
I mean, you got a link to on your IG for a YouTube video.
Definitely.
Right.
Yeah. That's
right. Who's the cat that you was rocking with on there?
That's my boy Zay.
Okay.
That's my boy Zay the man. We was working on some stuff together. That's some old stuff we did.
Okay.
Dope video.
Yeah, I do my research. I went and checked you out and shit. You know what I mean? I follow you on all that shit. So you know what I'm saying? That's how we get down.
Right. Appreciate it.
Right.
Much love.
If all y'all could follow the 360 radio on everything, man. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
With the whole team. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, man.
Check out the other shows, and let them know.
Right. Every Monday night, Connected Radio with Katie McGee. You know what I'm saying? Every Tuesday night. Oh no, Tap In is on Katie's show too. You know what I'm saying? And then Tuesday, I believe Tap In does the Petty Bunch or Politely Radio, one of them. But
Tap
In got 2 shows.
Too.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that nigga talking
Tap
big shit.
All
that,
Ashley,
the politest
Ashley.
Man. Yeah, shout out all Ashley too. And then on some Sundays, Coach JT be in here doing a. His sports show, you know what I'm saying? Bringing legends in the building, too. So.
And look out for next week. We don't do our little special little Christmas show. So we're going to do something a little special.
We're doing a holiday special. You know what
Might
saying?
Invite some people.
We're going to invite
Shout
some.
Out Mariah Carey.
Shout out Mariah Carey.
Hey, Dirk said that nigga is not coming to the holiday special if you don't play Mariah Carey.
Oh, we playing him. Come on.
So we got to play the Mariah.
Come on, Dirk. You know come on, Dirk.
Nah,
Dirk
is coming. You know what I'm saying?
The island.
We're going to reach out to some people. But yeah, we ain't got a definite guest list. Next week we're gonna be in here celebrating. You know what I'm saying? It's right for the holidays. We're gonna do some gift exchanges. You know what I'm saying?
And then that
might bring some food
after that show. We're gone until after New Year's, right?
Yeah. No Christmas. No New Year's.
No Christmas.
Man,
we're
with our families, man.
We gotta be with the family, man. You know what I'm saying? But Katie will be here. You know, the rest of the squad will be here on the days following that. But yeah. Next week's show is the last show of the year, so make sure y'all tune in. We're gonna make it a special event. You know what I'm saying? And follow the 360 radio and everything. Make sure y'all get to Uptown Takeout this Friday for Uptown Vibes. You know what I'm saying? If it ain't raining, you know what I mean? Hopefully.
It best not be raining.
You know what I'm saying? And then, yeah, follow everybody that you see here, man. Follow Eddie Z. Follow Dodi Unknown. Follow This Should Go Ray Simo. You know what I'm saying? Andy Holyfield.
Go Ray Simo.
Radio. Go Ramico.
Go Ramico. Ramathorn.
You know what I'm saying? But follow Eddie. Follow Incredible 916. Justin Z, you know what I'm saying? He on his cryptocurrency shit, you know what I'm saying? Teaching a thing or two about the whole world.
Doing
so
a little mining.
Tap in, you know what I'm saying? Mining. Tap in with LB the Great, you know what I'm saying?
Go pick up that 316. Go pick up that Council Culture. Go pick up that Humphrey Dogart.
You need
and
it.
And look out for that.
Life.
Go.
Shout out.
25th. On the 25th, they can pre-save, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shout out.
Hey, and shout out my son.
Hey.
Giuliano. I told him. You know,
shout out Giuliano.
Boy, Valentino.
There you go.
CC, what's happening? The whole fam. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt. Shout out to my children. All three
definitely.
Of y'all.
That's the motivation.
Yeah. Definitely. We'll do it for the kids.
Check back in later to call in for your requests, and we're going to do a sexy hot scissor line.
Scissor line?
Yeah. I don't know.
I gotta
get
that voice down.
Los hermanos Palomino, como sientas en la película, hey, güey.
Telemundo!
Lunes, Univision.
Either you got it or you don't.
Carlos, come in esos tracos también. Los hermanos.
We got.
R.I.P. Vicente Fernandez. Vicente.
R.I.P.
Rest in peace.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's yeah. I was just hearing something.
Rest in peace, man.
R.I.P. Man. Tired of saying R.I.P. Man. Hug your people. Let your people know you love them. You know what I'm saying? Y'all stay safe out there.
Go tell somebody about Top Shelf. You bitch.
Right.
Because we ain't mid shelf.
Hopefully y'all have a good week, man. You know, we just in here doing what we love, man. We appreciate each and every one of y'all to tune in. We'll be back next week with the holiday special, man. We out of here.
Yeah.
And my dog.
Can we play that Locksmith song?
When I get really beat up 30 people.